93 WBTP Clearwater, 96.7 FM W224 BE Brandon. Streaming live on the free iHeartRadio app. Listen for all your music, sports, talk, and podcasts. Free never sounded so good.
So good. So good. So good.
It's time, man. The stage is set.
Welcome, welcome.
Welcome home, baby.
I like this kind of party.
Putting the fun in dysfunctional.
Yeah!
Each and every weekday morning, the Pat and Aaron Show.
Is this a little too early for being that loud?
Good morning, Tampa Bay.
And here we go.
Now your hosts, Pat Donovan and Aaron Jacobson.
Good morning, goons. Welcome to the Pat and Aaron Show, 95.3 WDAE and AM 620. Coming to you live on a Wector Wednesday. I got to tell you, I feel like today, Aaron... Right. This is a great week, first of all, because we've got the Sweet 16 starting back up this weekend, actually on Thursday after Rays opening day. But I feel like today is the beginning of an entire celebration leading into this weekend. Like the rest of this week is just fantastic, of course. Later today.
You've said today is a celebration. What's tomorrow? If today's a celebration, what are we doing
today,
tomorrow?
Today, I said, is the beginning of a celebration.
That's right. Okay.
Now, today... We will, on the show, talk a lot about Rays opening day and talk a lot about Major League Baseball and that sort of thing. But why I say today is the beginning of a celebration is later today, you, myself, many of us here at WDAE will all be over at the Seminole Hard Rock Hotel and Casino for the final Ronnie and T-Kraz show, which, of course, begins at 3. It will be from 3 to 6 today. They're going live from the L Bar right there at the casino. And I know we're all going to be, at least most of us, I don't know, some people might not be able to make it, whatever. I know a lot of us are going to be there from here from WDAE. I imagine some other dignitaries from a lot from around iHeartRadio.
Sorry, I didn't mean to distract you, but I'm throwing up L-bombs on the YouTube, Facebook.
What's L-bomb?
L-bomb. Yeah, we're going to the L-bar. L-bomb.
Oh, L-bar, okay.
Yeah, L-bar, we're going to the L-bomb. That's what I drop.
You know what it kind of reminded me of? Am I on the screen? Yeah, so anybody watching now, what you did here with this thing, right? It kind of reminded me of like maybe like a home run celebration that someone might do or something like that that I've seen around Major League Baseball. And I thought like, is he trying to give me a symbol or a sign that's like trying to tell me someone, a dignitary, because I know there are several that may come by that's going to be there today at the Seminole Hard Rock Hotel and Casino.
Yeah, Larry Johnson, L-bomb.
Yeah.
Well, that's again, what we're getting. We're getting LJ.
Listen. I would take LJ and Grandmama.
Yeah,
all right?
Would.
I'll take them both. Dude, I was a teenager during the Grandmama days. Like, that was the bleep. Like, we loved Grandmama. Everyone. It didn't matter if you were a Larry Johnson fan, Knicks fan. Like, you just loved Grandmama. Those commercials are fantastic.
And I just dropped the L-bombs when I hit a long straight in Yahtzee.
Is that what you do?
Yeah. I love a good long straight in Yahtzee. I love a Yahtzee in Yahtzee.
What now? What's a long... For those of us who don't play Yahtzee, now I know a little bit about Yahtzee. I think I've dabbled.
Oh, John Mamola's going to love this. We're doing a tutorial on Yahtzee.
Yeah,
to start
you're damn
off.
Right.
This is my fault.
Yeah.
But yeah, L-bomb, long
What's
straight.
What's a long straight?
When you get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, you get 5 of them. And the short straight, there's a long straight and a short straight.
You mean?
No, on the dice. You get 6 dice, you roll the dice.
Oh, you know
like
what?
5 dice.
I'm
five
thinking
dice.
Of the one where you spell words. What is that?
I don't do that. Scrabble?
Is it Scrabble?
Yeah, Scrabble. Love Scrabble. Right. Yeah.
You're like, I don't do that.
I love Scrabble. I know. I realized I'm an idiot.
Not as much as you love Major League Baseball. And the Rays return to action tomorrow. Speaking of returning to action, yesterday, obviously, we got the final tune-up for a kid that I'm really excited about this season in Ryan Pepiot. But then, after Ryan Pepiot, the final 3 innings of the game... Jake Odorizzi, like that's a name we haven't heard for a while. Certainly being on a mound and pitching for the Rays. He hasn't pitched at all since 2022. You never know. Obviously, he's a guy that's not going to be ready to go anytime soon. It doesn't sound like. But I had a good article Mark Topkin did yesterday in the Tampa Bay, or actually maybe it's this morning in the Tampa Bay Times, TampaBay.com. You know, just kind of talking about how. For Jake, this was kind of like a measuring stick of not whether or not he was ready, but instead how soon he might be ready. But it was cool just to see him out there. Well, not to see him with my own two eyes, but to see that he was out there for the Rays as they wrapped up spring training.
They very much could need him, and soon. You know, he's a guy.
I almost expect it, don't you?
It depends. I don't expect it because it's a lot to throw at him early on. We've talked about Waggis Pack.
I'm not talking about early on. I'm just talking about in general. At some point,
I think
they're
going to
need someone, right?
Yeah, when we talk about, you know, Taj Bradley with the injury, Shane Boz is having some trouble getting back. We're going to need someone to step up here, and it's going to be, I'm thinking Waggis Pack. And Odorizzi's going to have a shot to do it as well, but it might take a little time. But there, he might be a name that we're calling on later down the road that could come through in a big way if he stays healthy. He's got to stay healthy.
No doubt about it. And again, I'm very much myself looking forward to more of Ryan Pepiot as we get into the season and just really getting to see a lot of him, because he's a guy, four more strikeouts yesterday.
Incredible.
Has really looked good his last two times out for the Rays. And, you know, he's a kid that all of the signs point to him being able to be a very good starter in this league. And you can only hope more reliable from a health standpoint than Tyler Glasnow was. And as much as we all loved Tyler as a human being, that was one of the things that we always had to worry about, was whether he could stay healthy. And they need to find somebody in this rotation that's durable outside of Zach Eflin.
Or durability doesn't exist.
Zach Eflin threw a lot of innings last year, and I know he's, you know, he's not bulletproof, but he showed some durability last year.
Ryan Pepiot, a guy who's going to be taking the hill for the Rays' fifth game this season. He ended the spring with, in 13 and a third innings, 16 strikeouts, 3 walks.
Yeah.
That is what I'm looking at. That's the indicator to me. It always has been. It's why I've always had trouble getting behind guys like Chris Archer, at times getting behind guys like Blake Snell, because, yeah, they'll strike out a lot of guys, but you look at the walks and you look, it just doesn't add up. It's not something you want to see from a pitcher in the league right now, the way it is right now. That ratio, it's got to be like that. A 16-3 is fantastic. For a guy who is trying to figure it out in spring, to have that stat, that's tremendous.
I was just going to say that. It's kind of interesting, and we'll have to talk to Doug Wechter about this, right? Because you can look at it in two ways. I think, and I was originally thinking the same thing as you, right? Where it's like, hey, as Doug has explained to us, you're never just out there throwing your best stuff or the stuff that you might throw in any given situation in the spring, because a lot of times you're, like you said, you're working on things. So to do that while you're still working on things is really impressive. Now, on the flip side, if you want to be completely fair and objective, right, you could say he probably struck out a lot of guys this spring that won't be playing in the majors this year, right? You obviously don't know who he struck out in every appearance and all that stuff, but I'm sure he struck out a handful of guys, at least out of those 16, that aren't going to be seeing major league pitching this year. So it works both ways. But I still think overall, listen, even the kids that get sent down, even the kids that aren't going to be major leaguers this year, they were in a major league camp for a reason. And to be striking out hitters good enough to be in a major league camp for a reason while you're still working on stuff, I'd rather focus on that positive than the potential negative.
So that, I see a lot of positives, and I'm looking forward to watching that, as you are. And back to Jake Odorizzi, it just can't have any setbacks. And then he should get an opportunity. But he's not old. He's 33 years old. Yeah. There still should be, as long as he stays healthy, a return, not to his former self, but he's always been a smart pitcher. And you put him back with Kyle Snyder, and you saw the production from Jake Odorizzi when he went over to the Twins. Extremely productive. Injuries have set him back.
Yeah.
You get with Kyle Snyder again. You hopefully stay healthy, which is always the outlier. And if you do, maybe we can recreate some magic from the past and have that veteran presence around this clubhouse that could just be so massive.
And I think that's the best point, is he doesn't have to come in here and be Shane McClanahan. That's not the expectation at all. He can come in here and be productive and be a big part of this ball club, and that's just what the Rays do. And I'm sure what we're going to see them have to do this year, and we'll talk about some of the guys that ended up one guy in the rotation and one guy in the pen, you know, in a little while here on the show. By the way, 6:45, we're going to give out a pair of 4-pack, actually, of Rays tickets for Friday's game as well. So a lot coming up on the show today, but we also want to get your predictions. There's been a lot of, I think, trepidation about this Rays season. We talked about it the other day. Zach Blobner went as far as to say the Rays could be cursed this season. I'm not anywhere near that boat, but I am far from optimistic, Aaron. As a guy who sat here and will make predictions later in the show, we'd love to hear yours, 888-546-4620, or you can text your thoughts to the Bartow Ford DAE text line, 82945. Message and data rates may apply. I believe I said 100 or 101 games last season was my prediction, and they didn't get there, even though they get off to a historic start, right? My prediction, I will tell you right now, will not be anywhere near 101 victories for the Rays this season.
Are you over 90? Over, under 90?
Under. I think I'm under.
I think I'm under. I think I can.
Like, I've got a number in mind. I've sat on it all night, literally up all night for some reason, not sleeping and thinking about the Rays. I want to be more optimistic. And listen, I wouldn't be shocked if they beat the number that I put out there this year, because if you just write this team off, shame on you. We've seen this enough from this team that they just find ways. Kevin Cash just finds ways. But what about you? Over, under 90?
Over.
Okay.
Did you?
I like it. Mae you will convince me otherwise. That's
no,
why I want that.
I will not be convincing anybody. I have my prediction, rude. And that's it. Did you see the new turf yesterday?
Yeah, I've seen a couple of angles of it. Now, I think it was Rock Riley posted some the other day of the new turf, or maybe it was Doug, but
it was
regardless,
Doug.
It looked a little dirty. Like, I was like, what's all over the field? But then I've seen since, it was probably just clay that got kind of moved around or whatever. I've seen since where it just looks unbelievable.
I hope it feels good.
It's supposedly softer. I've already read that.
It has to be. Has to be because... I don't know. I have such a level of extra added respect for anyone that has to play at the Trob. Over the years of playing the media game, it's like a concrete court out there.
Yeah.
It can be really challenging at times. Those things for the outfielder.
You do it once.
For an outfielder, it's crazy.
Yeah.
So I'm glad it's softer.
You do it once.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
What's your point?
Do it for a week. Like, you play basketball, like, we've all, like, grown up, like, we've in the summer where we've played basketball every day, right? By the end of the week, your body feels different than it does at the beginning of the week. You're doing it every day almost all year,
Well, there's visiting teams coming in that are only playing a couple days.
No, I'm talking about from a Rays standpoint.
Oh, yeah, well, it's tough. I'm just glad that it's softer.
Dude, I'm not disagreeing with you at all. My point is...
You get used to it,
Notice it. No, but you notice it, right?
Yeah.
You notice it, and you play there once. Imagine these guys that have to play there all the time.
Yeah, they probably hate it.
We've heard that from guys.
And sliding. Kevin Kiermaier went back in the day, diving on that stuff.
It hurts.
My God. It hurts.
Dude, it's like trying to buy a house with the wrong lender.
It
hurts.
Exactly what
you
it is.
You can't do that, man.
It's exactly what I was thinking.
You can run headfirst into a wall and look like an idiot, or you could call John Howard and HowardTeamHomeLoans.com and get things done the right way.
I thought you ran into a car.
Well, no, we're not talking about me right now.
Oh, okay.
We're talking about people trying to buy a home.
Oh, my bad.
All right? No, it's okay. It's okay. Listen, I didn't run into a car either. I got hit by a car. All right?
I forgot
that. It drove into me. All right?
I'm the worst. I just assumed you ran into it.
No. The car hit me. I did not hit the car. All right? Well, I hit the car, but the car hit me first, and then I bounced off the car. Regardless, if I was buying a home at the time, I would have got right up off the ground and remembered HowardTeamHomeLoans.com because I would have said, listen, I've already bumped my head off the car. The last thing I need is to keep bumping my head trying to buy a home. And it can happen. Listen, we've all been there. We've all dealt with lenders where it felt like they were not trying to help us. And the reality is that John Howard goes out of his way for clients. We've told you about so many, from the gentleman trying to use his VA loan that kept being told he didn't qualify because he was working with lazy lenders that didn't manually underwrite those loans. John Howard does that. We told you about the guy he helped get a roof, which saved him $9,000 on his insurance every single year. If you're in a spot where maybe bills are a little tight, maybe some of that credit card debt is piling up, sometimes a cash out refinance can be the best option for you. And that's another reason why it's great to be able to reach out to John Howard and HowardTeamHomeLoans.com, because John will sit down with you. He'll look at your finances and he'll literally tell you the best plan, whether it be a cash out refinance or not. He'll put you in a better financial position tomorrow than you're in today. Again, whether it's using a cash out refinance or another option, John Howard will put you in a better spot. So if you're in that spot thinking about doing a cash out refinance, or you want to get a loan and you don't want to use the wrong lender, HowardTeamHomeLoans.com. I always say it, if you're driving, just pull over. HowardTeamHomeLoans.com. When we return, it's time for today's top headlines with Casey Warner next on the Pat and Aaron Show, 95.3 WDAE and AM 620.
From the Whatever It Takes Moss Nissan Traffic Center.
WDAE. Traffic update.
Earlier crash on southbound 275 near the St. Pete side of the Howard Franklin Bridge now clear. Same goes for overnight construction in this area. All lanes are open. Traffic getting back up to speed through there. We are seeing delays, though, in St. Pete on southbound 275 near 175. Two right lanes are blocked there due to overnight construction and a crash being cleared on 92 and Mango Road. With traffic, I'm Randy Myers.
This report is sponsored by Audible. Come to Audible and discover the best selection of audiobooks without exception. Bestsellers, new releases, plus podcasts and exclusive Audible originals. You'll find everything you love all in one place. Sign up for a free 30-day trial at audible.com.
Hey guys, T. Kraz and Ronnie for C4MH.com. It's the holiday season, and with that comes those New Year's resolutions to hit the gym. But remember, guys, if you're over 40, you can't build muscle with low T.
That's right, T. Kraz. Testosterone is the primary hormone needed for building muscle, and if your testosterone is low, you'll be working twice as hard at the gym and getting nowhere. So know before you go and get your testosterone tested at C4MH.com. Just $45 gets you lab tests and a medical exam.
And you'll not only see results in the gym. I've been going to C4MH.com for years now, and I feel great, healthier, stronger, and my overall mood has improved too.
Beware of pop-up men's clinics that use cheap-cut rate compounded testosterone and want you to pay in advance. C4MH.com only treats with pharmaceutical testosterone and never makes you pay for treatments in advance. No financial contracts to sign, no financing needed, as C4MH.com is a medical clinic, not a marketing company. Just $170 a month for treatments and $90 for labs twice a year. No surprises, no upsells or add-ons. And you can walk in at any of their 18 locations when it's your time for treatment. Just walk in, get your treatment, walk out, no appointment, no waiting.
C4MH.com is the leader in low-T care and has been since 2011. 18 locations between Tarpon Springs and Naples. It's safe, affordable, convenient. Visit C4MH.com and click on Express Treatment, and you're on your way to feeling better at C4MH.com.
Sneezing, coughing, stuffy nose, runny nose, post-nasal drip, interrupted sleeping. I was groggy at the end of the day.
Allergies and sinus congestion were making Jana miserable. Then a friend recommended Navage. Navage provides immediate drug-free congestion relief, flushing your nasal passages with refreshing saline and sucking out mucus, germs, and other airborne irritants. Navage helps you breathe easier, sleep better, and feel your best right away.
Navage gave me instant relief. I didn't have to wait 30 minutes. I didn't have to wait an hour, 90 minutes. I didn't have to wait a minute. I ran the rinse and I felt better.
Stop suffering from congestion and start breathing and feeling your best again with Navage. N-A-V-A-G-E.
I've had people ask me how I find relief, and I tell them Navage immediately. This thing is amazing.
Navage is available at Navage.com or at Walmart, Walgreens, CVS, and Rite Aid.
Ronnie Lane here, joined by the MVP of the Holland Group Retirement Wealth Advisors, co-founder and president, Elizabeth Holland.
The one thing I love most about football is the team effort it takes to win a game. All phases of the team have to work together and be at their very best to get the job done.
That's what your team at the Holland Group does every day, right? Your team of advisors, led by Steve and you, puts together comprehensive retirement plans designed to preserve and grow assets while applying tax advantage strategies to make sure your clients keep every single cent they are legally entitled to. That's what I call a win.
That's exactly right. And unlike most other financial firms, we do it all under one roof. This is where the Holland Group becomes your X factor, and we can design a customized, inflation-adjusted, and tax advantage retirement plan.
Nobody wins by sitting on the bench, so call the Hollands at 727-469-7939 or visit askthehollands.com. Let's make the rest of your life the best of your life.
The college basketball excitement has begun, and you could be on your way to see the championship game live on April 8th with Duffy Sports Grill's MVP Huge March Giveaway. Every visit now through March 31st will earn you an entry. The more you visit, the better your chances to win. So grab your MVP card and head over to Duffy's and enjoy their new courtside favorites, award-winning certified Angus beef burgers and two-for-one drinks all day, every day. And remember,
at Duffy's, our game is always on.
An iHeartRadio sports report presented by Mark Spain Real Estate.
This report is sponsored by Rasmussen University.
I had so many dreams, but life quickly got in the way. Then
Rasmussen University saw my true potential and gave me the support and confidence I needed to become who I am today. Rasmussen University. Learn more at rasmussen.edu/Florida.
Mostly cloudy today. Slight chance of showers, more likely in the afternoon. Our high 83. Overnight, a better chance of showers, 70% chance. Our low will drop back to 71. Tomorrow, more of the same. Mostly cloudy in the morning. Slight chance of showers and thunderstorms. About a 70% chance, actually, in the morning. And then sunny in the afternoon. Our high right around 76.
Have you downloaded the free iHeartRadio app yet? Just think, you could take WDAE and your home for sports, music, talk, and podcasts all on one app.
Free never sounded so good.
Presented by the law offices of Anajar and Levine, accident attorneys. Call 1-800-747-FREE.
That's 1-800-747-3733.
Top headlines.
Time for today's top headlines, brought to you by Mark Spain Real Estate, Casey Warner.
All right, here we go. First thing we got, Jordan Montgomery, who shut down the Rays quite a bit last year. Pretty good season, I'd say. Reigning NL champions, Arizona Diamondbacks agree to a one-year, $25 million deal with Jordan Montgomery. The final domino in MLB free agency has seemed to have fallen, and the Diamondbacks are looking to run back another National League championship. Great signing for them.
It's just crazy what's happened with star pitchers. Blake Snell.
Yep.
You know, Jordan Montgomery with short contracts. It's obviously not the same thing, but you know what it reminds me of? The franchise tag in football. It feels like, obviously, they're going to different teams, so it's not the same concept.
And they're not getting, I don't think they're getting quite top five money necessarily.
True. You know what
I
mean? Yeah. But these like short deals are just so new. And it's a really, I commend the player in a way, because you're not taking that long-term deal and potentially shutting it down.
It's ballsy.
Like Rendon's doing in LA. He's been doing for years. These guys are taking a chance and betting on themselves.
Aaron, that's not fair at all. Okay. Baseball's just not a priority for him.
He's the worst. If I was an Angels fan, oh my gosh, I would be so mad at Anthony Rendon. I would hate Anthony Rendon.
Yeah. Teams are going to want to keep going in this direction, though. I mean, if you're a Major League Baseball team, you've got to be pretty psyched about pitchers being willing to take short-term deals. By the way, if you're watching on the live stream and you're like, what the hell is around Pat's neck? That's the very cool. I'll put my neck up here so you can see it. If you're watching on YouTube, you can watch on YouTube, Facebook, Twitch. Like and subscribe on YouTube. This is the Jose Siri replica necklace that I've got on my neck here today. If you're watching on the live stream, you can get that on Sunday at the Rays game at the Trop.
If you could, first 12,000 fans, if you could get Tyler Glass now for just 1 year, $25 million. Would you? Of course, the Rays weren't going to do a long term like the Dodgers did and what Tyler Glasnow was looking for. But
he's already under contract, too. So there wasn't with the Rays. You know what I mean? Like he would have been, I can't remember what the deal was going to be for this coming year. You know what I mean? Under the Rays contract. But yes, to answer your question just directly, yes, I would do that.
It makes me wonder why the Rays don't. Now that this is how it's going, where you can get a really good pitcher on a prove it deal for $20 to $25 million, why you wouldn't take a chance and spend a little money to bring in? We know how valuable arms are, and I know that they're, you know, probably looking at it like, hey, he might go down with an injury, but you can't think like that. And if you got one arm to help you out, one stud, the things might change a lot.
I don't disagree with you. I still think, and I've been saying this for a while, it's not that the Rays aren't trying to win this year. I still think that they look at it logically, as I think I do, and a lot of fans probably do, as this is probably going to be a bumpy year, and next year we're going to have a chance to be really, really good. Do we kind of just suck it up for a year financially? Like, it sucks. I'd love to be a little bit better, but are they going to do enough to be a World Series contender this year? And if not, would I rather they keep those resources for next year? I would.
They might. I hate to keep making the football comparisons, but they might be like the Bucks. The Bucks aren't spending. You know, they spent money, but they didn't bring any stars, and they couldn't really do it. They had to retain their guys. The Rays didn't really bring anyone in. They made a couple deals, a couple trades here and there, a couple small deals here and there, but no stars. I think the Bucks are going to be okay. I don't think they can win it all. I think the Rays have a better shot to win it all than the Buccaneers just because the way they're built.
This season,
yeah.
I would actually say I think the Bucks do.
Just
because of how momentum can happen in football. And
you get some starting arms back later on in the year if the Rays are in it. Maybe those guys, maybe it's the reverse. Instead of getting hurt early and having to exit and all our dreams keep being washed away, maybe the momentum builds on our dreams. We go into the season thinking it's not looking too good. Then you start getting those arms back in the starting rotation. Some guys start to take form, and you know there is a name that we will not be talking about right now. We will not be talking about probably in the next couple of weeks that we will be talking about later on down the road, and that person will be producing for the Rays. It happens every year. I say it every year, and it happens every year.
I still think you need a Shane McClanahan, Drew Rasmus, and a Jeffrey Springs. You need a couple of those guys back, and not just like kind of back, but back. You know what I mean? And that's why I think next year is the year you're going to either have those guys back at the beginning or very early in the year, where like you could look at this staff at some point next year and be like, this rotation is ridiculous. And we certainly aren't going to say that at any point this year, unfortunately.
Listen, we're hoping to get some of the guys you named back. And hopefully we get a full, I don't think they're going to throw them on the mound unless they're ready to go full force.
We'll find out tomorrow. First pitch is at 4:10. Opening day, be there, be square. From the penalty box, back to you all.
Do not be square. Do not be square.
It's the worst thing to be.
It's sold out, by the way.
But be there anyways. Yeah. Hey, if you can't get there tomorrow, all right, we'll be there tomorrow morning. But if you can't get there tomorrow, you can get there on Friday. We're going to give out tickets at 6:45 today. On the Bartow Ford DA text line, and we're asking for your predictions on the season, how many victories the Rays will have. On the Bartow Ford DA text line, we got a definitely over 90. Also, 85 to 90 wins and a wild card would be great. So those are a couple of early predictions. If you want to get yours in, again, 82945. If you want to text the show, start your text with DAE so that we get it. Also, 888-546-4620. And don't forget, we'll be, like I said, at Tropicana Field all day tomorrow, starting at sunrise when Aaron and I are there for the morning show, straight on through the new afternoon show with Tom Krasnicki, which tomorrow will be 12 to 3 because, of course, the Rays game is at 4 o'clock. We're going right through the game all day live from Tropicana Field and presented by the Central Florida Behavioral Health Network and the Department of Children and Families and your home of Rays Baseball, 95.3 WDAE and AM 620. Yesterday, or actually I think it was the day before, Kevin Cash made a comment and says the Rays, they rounded out the pitching staff with a couple of guys that he would call Ray-ish. But is that a great thing? We'll talk about who they are and whether or not it could be a good thing next on the Pat and Aaron Show, 95.3 WDAE and AM 620.
Live from the Seminole Hard Rock Hotel and Casino. Today, we invite you to the final Ronnie and T-Crass program as our own version of Batman and Robin sail into the sunset one final time. So bring your tissues, your memories, and a stiff drink and a cigar for one final toast in honor of the most hideous show in Tampa Bay radio history. On the radio home of the Ronnie and T-Crass show since 2014, 95.3 WDAE and AM 620, Tampa Bay Sports Radio.
Some days I cover up because of my moderate to severe plaque psoriasis. Now I'm hitting the road with clearer skin thanks to Skyrizi, Risankizumab Riza, a prescription-only 150 milligram injection for adults who are candidates for systemic or phototherapy. With Skyrizi, 3 out of 4 people achieved 90% clearer skin at 4 months. And Skyrizi is just 4 doses a year after 2 starter doses.
Don't use if allergic to Skyrizi. Serious allergic reactions and an increased risk of infections or a lower ability to fight them may occur. Before treatment, your doctor should check for infection and tuberculosis. Tell your doctor if you have an infection or symptoms, such as fever, sweats, chills, muscle aches, or cough, or if you plan to or recently received a vaccine.
Thanks to Skyrizi, there's nothing on my skin, and that means everything. Ask your doctor today about Skyrizi, the number one dermatologist-prescribed biologic in psoriasis. And visit Skyrizi.com or call 1-866-SKYRIZI to learn more.
I spray and scrub, but the soap scum in my bathtub is still there.
I spray and scrub, but the burnt sauce on my stovetop sticks around.
Sprays can leave grime behind, but new Mr. Clean Ultra Foamy Magic Eraser combines the scrubbing power of an eraser with the cleaning power of Dawn to melt away tough messes on contact.
Just wet, squeeze, and erase.
Stop spraying, start erasing, and clean with more magic than ever with new Ultra Foamy Magic Eraser.
Mr. Clean, Mr. Clean.
This Easter weekend, hop on over to Pool Perfection's grand opening of their second location. With 20 years of experience and top-notch quality, they're bringing the best to North Tampa communities. Just 2 miles west of the Tampa Premium Outlets on State Road 54. Join the festivities this Saturday, 10 a.m. to 5 p.m., and Sunday from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. Indulge in delicious food and exciting fun as you explore what Pool Perfection has to offer. Plus, for those attending, there are fantastic incentives in store if you're considering building that pool. Don't miss out on the treats this weekend. Come celebrate with Pool Perfection.
I feel good.
Dad, are you singing to your cereal?
Yes, I am. Like I knew that I would.
No, a dance too?
Come on, Ava. Silk almond milk. Starts the morning on a high note. Yow!
Songs, dances, and dad jokes.
Oh, so good. So good. I got you.
Silk almond milk.
With calcium, vitamins A, D, and E.
Feel plenty good.
Join us for our 2024 iHeartRadio Music Awards, live from the Dolby Theater in Hollywood.
Monday, April 1st. Watch on Fox, starting at 8 p.m. And listen on the free iHeartRadio app.
Tesla Apprentalast is a proud partner of the iHeartRadio Music Awards, a celebration of artists and the fans who got them there, the fans who make the music truly come alive through their energy and positive vibes. To the fans that make live music possible, we salute you.
Hey everyone, it's Ted from Consumer Cellular, the guy in the orange sweater, and this is your wake-up call. If you're paying too much for wireless service, you don't have to keep having that nightmare. Consumer Cellular has the same fast, reliable coverage as the leading carriers for up to half the cost. So why keep spending more than you have to? Seriously, wake up and call 1-888-FREEDOM or visit ConsumerCellular.com.
Savings based on cost of Consumer Cellular single line 1, 5, and 10 gig data plans with unlimited talk and text compared to lowest cost single line postpaid unlimited talk, text, and data plans offered by T-Mobile and Verizon January 2024.
For the best live thoroughbred horse racing action, you don't have to go far. Right here in our backyard at Tampa Bay Downs. Free on Wednesdays, $3 only on Fridays, Saturdays, and Sundays. They've got tip sheets for the inexperienced bettors, so check them out. The best racing around, TampaBayDowns.com.
I'm Ellie Anajar of Anajar & Levine. Injured in a car crash? Never rush to settle with insurance companies and never settle for just any attorney. Demand Anajar & Levine. Our experienced legal team will fight to win you the maximum compensation you deserve. Call me, Ellie Anajar, for a free consultation and take back control of your life. Call 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
Main office, Tampa.
When you enter a place of business, you're owed a legal duty that the place of business is safe for you to shop in. I'm John Morgan of Morgan & Morgan. If you suffered an injury at a place of business, our duty is to protect you after that harm. Morgan & Morgan, for the people.com.
Trajan Wealth, your trusted local fiduciary advisors. Visit TrajanWealth.com.
Here's what's trending from the iHeart Sports Network, presented by DraftKings Fantasy.
The Rays played the Tigers to a tie in their final spring training game yesterday, opening day coming up tomorrow against Toronto. The NCAA tournament resumes tomorrow with Sweet 16 games in the East and the West regionals. The West region games include Alabama against North Carolina, Bama, and Tennessee, who plays Friday, are the only remaining SEC teams. And hockey, the Lightning back on the ice tonight against Boston. I'm Matt McCoy.
Check out what DraftKings has to offer this season with code SPORTS, because life's more fun when you're in on the action. DraftKings, the crown is yours. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER. Age and eligibility restrictions apply. Void where prohibited. See DraftKings.com for details.
Broadcasting from the Rude Air Conditioning Studios, this is Tampa Bay Sports Radio, 95.3 WDAE and AM 620.
How many victories are the Rays going to have this season? 888-546-4620. You can also text your thoughts to the Bartow 4 DAE text line, 82945. Start your text with DAE. Message and data rates may apply. Last text we just got in, a solid prediction followed up by a disgusting one within one text. Rays 87 wins. I think that's a fair prediction. And 12 more months of stadium talk with no definites. That is a disgusting prediction and something that cannot happen. And St. Pete, you better get off your tookus. Listen to Janet Long, all right? She gives a damn. I don't know what the rest of you idiots are doing. No offense, idiots. But come on, listen to Janet Long and let's get this thing done. Because I'm tired of the discussion, and certainly starting tomorrow, it's a discussion we're not having.
Listen to Janet Long.
Yeah. Listen, let's get shirts. Can we call Jeff Atenella right now? Jeff Atenella, if you're listening, call us. You know, you've got the Jeff Atenella hotline. Call us right now and tell us if we can get, like, some kind of shirts celebrating Janet Long and her dedication to keeping the Rays in St. Pete, unlike some of her cohorts.
We brought up earlier L-bombs. Is Janet Long the new L-bomb? Long?
That's what we should do.
L-bombs?
Listen, when this stadium gets built, she needs a day or something. There's no urgency outside of Mrs. Long. Okay?
Are you Mrs. Long? Are you ready for predictions? Do you want to give them now? Are we waiting a little bit? How do you want to do this? I'm at the edge of my seat here.
I'd say we give our predictions in a couple of minutes. Oh. And by the way, we'll give out Rays tickets, a 4-pack for Friday, coming up in about 10 minutes. But first, I do want to pay off what we mentioned before the break, which is that the Rays, they filled out their pitching staff with a guy in the rotation and a guy in the bullpen who Kevin Cash called Ray-ish. And it was actually in an article that was on RaysBaseball.com from Adam Berry. And he just talked about how, obviously, when you look at Tyler Alexander, Aaron mentioned Jacob Wagus back earlier in the show. Tyler Alexander was claimed from the Tigers back in November. He's going to be the last starter for now while Taj Bradley is on the shelf.
And he'll actually be, for the way it's lined up, I believe he'll pitch the fourth game.
Yeah, but he's still the fifth starter, right?
I don't even know if he's a starter. He's starting the game, right? But we know, and this is what I'm getting to, is we know the way the Rays work.
Yeah.
Like, he might not be starting in 2 months. Jake Wagus back.
But right now he is.
Yes. For this game, he is starting. And there are going to be guys that are going to be bulk guys. I don't know how long Alexander's going to be able to go. He's had, you know, a handful of outings in his career where he's gotten 6 innings of work. So he can go the distance. And we know how Kevin Cash likes to work early in the season. The guys are not going to be stretched out that long. So I expect some bulk roles to be done by some guys like a Wagus back.
Well, listen, we've seen guys with much higher expectations for this team work limited innings than a guy like Tyler Alexander, right? So obviously, you know, he's not a guy we're going to expect to go 7-8 innings at any point. But Kevin Cash is talking about him as part of the rotation, at least for now, again, while Taj Bradley's on the shelf. And then the last guy in the bullpen ended up being that Jacob Wagus pack. And Kevin Cash was talking about it the other day, talking about the fact that a guy who was a non-roster invitee in Wagus pack and a guy that was a waiver claim in Tyler Alexander were both going to make this team, one in the rotation, one in the bullpen. And Kevin Cash said it's pretty Ray-ish. And he's right. And it's basically what you were referencing just a few minutes ago. There are always going to be guys that we don't really see coming. We're not probably very excited about when we find out that they're coming or that they're here. And then they end up making a pretty significant impact on this team.
Yeah, and it's hard to predict what the guy's roles are going to be. Like you said, he is starting out in the rotation, but there are so many guys. I mean, he beat out two other guys in Wagus Pack and Devinsky to get that role.
Yep.
And the way the Rays are, like, I could see Wagus Pack and Devinsky, both of them, in bulk roles and opener roles. I mean, the way Kevin Cash uses these guys, it's just hard to predict what the utilization will be and what they're going to become, because that's it. Guys become stronger. We saw it with Zach Littell last year. Yeah. Guys grow. They get stronger as the year goes on. We saw it a couple of years ago with Drew Rasmussen, who was a guy out of the bullpen and then turned out, you know, he's doing openings, doing some bulk, and then next thing you know, we're getting 7-8 innings out of him sometimes.
Well, the more the Snyder dust you get sprinkled on you, and eventually you never know what happens. Some guys, they just get, like, pretty good, and some guys, it's like, where did this come from?
The dream would be Alexander, a guy who started, by the way, 43 games in Major League Baseball as a starter. Starting pitcher, the dream would be that he just pitches well enough where we don't ever have to worry about it, and he finds himself into this rotation fitting in quite comfortably.
Yeah, no, if he can hold on to that spot until Taj Bradley is ready to take it back, that would be fantastic for this team. But to your point, if it doesn't happen, they should be okay, because nobody navigates having a less than complete rotation or a less than complete bullpen, which, by the way, on the flip side, the bullpen looks like it could be the strength of this team this year, right? Nobody has dealt with, whether it be in the bullpen or the rotation, some kind of deficiency better than Kevin Cash. I mean, sometimes it's almost like he turns it into a strength. It's ridiculous.
43 starts for Alexander. Three of those starts, he's gone seven innings or more. So, yeah, you look at the number three, and it's not that much. But out of 43 starts for a guy, the way the Rays are, yeah, that's fantastic. To see that number already, a guy who's kind of an underdog that had to fight his way into this rotation, I like what he's been able to do at times in his career.
But a number that probably won't change. With the Tampa Bay Rays, right?
Like, you never know.
I mean, you're right, because we've seen it from Rasmussen, like you said, right? And nobody expected that from him early on. But probably not.
Saw it from Littell last year.
Yeah. He was really... I'm excited to see what we get out of Zach this year. Talking to him before at FanFest about kind of his goals for this year and how he wants to grow as a guy who gets to walk into the season as a part of the rotation, not, you know, a kind of a question mark as to what he'd be doing. I'm really excited for that next step for him.
If we're being quite honest, all these guys are going to start. Like, the Rays are going to get hurt. Someone's going to get injured. It's just, and I know people are like, what is that? That's half glass empty. I'm a half glass full guy now. But
I am. When did that change?
I don't know, but it changed recently. But here's the thing. It's going to happen. Realistically, when you look at the history of the Rays, when you look at the history of the guys that are starting out the season in the rotation, someone's going to get hurt. You mentioned Zach Eflin. The guy's been dealing with injuries his entire career. You go back to Aaron Civale. He hasn't pitched more than 125 innings in a season in his career.
Yeah.
Because of dealing with some IL trips.
And that's a guy that's going to have to make me believe in him before I do.
So guys,
as far as being a top-end guy for us.
So 1-2 guy, 1-2 punch in the rotation to start the year. Guys that have battled injuries throughout their career. So it would be naive of us to think. It would be, in fact, maybe a little ignorant of us to assume that these guys are going to go through the season unscathed. I know it sounds negative, but it's just the fact.
Well, and that's why I'm nervous. That's why I have a lot of trepidation about this season, and predicting that they're going to win over 90 games is something I'm probably not going to be able to do for the first time in I think, years.
You just have to hope guys come in and help out, and they've been able to patch it up, and that's why I do have confidence that they do have the right pieces, and I think Kevin Cash... And the way that Eric Neander has to look to the future, how could they not plan for the contingency of injuries at this point? They've been through it so much. They're so jaded to it. I would think that that's a big part of their planning.
No doubt. But you can only be so deep. You know what I mean? You can only be 100%. So deep.
Absolutely.
And to be like a real contender, we need a couple of those guys that look like they could be Cy Young candidates. Like Springs and obviously McClanahan, I think, before we're ready to compete at that level. All right, when we return, your chance to win a 4-pack of tickets to see the Rays on Friday at Tropicana Field in Game 2. And we'll also talk a little bit about the Buccaneers. What does Baker Mayfield need to do better in 2024? We'll let Todd Bowles tell you next.
From the Whatever It Takes Moss Nissan Traffic Center.
WDAE. Traffic update.
Good morning. Delays now on southbound US 19, just south of Klosterman. A crash in this area blocking one lane. Also building traffic in Tampa, westbound I-4, approaching 275, and also west of Plant City on westbound I-4 near Branch Forbes Road. No major problems to report on I-75 throughout the area, and traffic also moving well in both directions on the Veterans Expressway. With traffic, I'm Randy Myers.
This report is sponsored by Rasmussen University.
I had so many dreams, but life quickly got in the way. Then Rasmussen University saw my true potential and gave me the support and confidence I needed to become who I am today. Rasmussen University. Learn more at rasmussen.edu/Florida.
Hey guys, T-Kraz here for C4MH.com. Well, it's the holiday season, and with all that comes the New Year's resolutions, guys, to hit the gym. But remember, if you're over 40, you can't build muscle with low T. Testosterone is the primary hormone needed for building muscle. And if you have low T, you'll be working twice as hard at the gym and getting nowhere. So know before you go. Get your testosterone tested at C4MH.com. Just $45 gets you lab results and a medical exam. And C4MH.com only treats with pharmaceutical testosterone. Never never that cheap cut rate compounded tea that all those pop-up tea clinics use. C4MH.com never makes you pay for treatments in advance. No financial contracts to sign. No financing needed, as C4MH.com is a medical clinic, not a marketing company. Just $85 for treatment twice a month and $90 for labs. No surprises and no upsells or add-ons. C4MH.com, the leader in low T care. 18 locations between Tarpon Springs and Naples. Hit them up at C4MH.com.
Ew, gotta get rid of this old Backstreet Boys t-shirt.
Tell me why.
Because it stinks, boys.
Tell me why.
I've washed it so many times, but the odor won't come out.
Tell me why.
No, you tell me why I can't get rid of this odor.
Have you tried Downy Rinse and Refresh? It doesn't just cover up odors. It helps remove them.
Wow, it worked, guys.
Yeah.
Downy Rinse and Refresh removes more odor in one wash than the leading value detergent in three washes. Find it wherever you buy laundry products.
The five-star review. It's as important to contractors as it is to customers. Service Titan can help you earn more stars with innovative software features designed to give your customers the most convenient, most modern experience possible. Take it from the guys at Rainforest Plumbing and Air.
Service Titan has enabled us to give each service call that personal touch.
We love it because we know who our customers are when they call us, and we even know if they have a favorite technician.
Start earning more five-star reviews. Schedule a demo today at servicetitan.com. That's servicetitan.com.
At Advent Health, we know the heart. We've mapped it, modeled it, repaired it, and rehabbed it. We've screened it, strengthened it, and saved it. We know your heart, and we know there's an unstoppable human spirit at the center of it. Learn more about Whole Person Care and find nationally recognized heart care specialists at AdventHealthCardiovascularInstitute.com.
Revar Buick GMC is the number two GMC dealer in the country, and they want to hold on to that number two. So they're going to keep doing what they've been doing to get there. Huge inventory, massive discounts, regardless of what time of the year it is. The middle, the end of the month, it doesn't matter. It's always a great deal. Unbeatable discounts. All you have to do is visit RevarBuickGMC.com. See for yourself. Try and find another dealer with discounts that insane on every vehicle. Revar Buick GMC. GMC, we are professional grade.
An iHeartRadio sports report presented by Mark Spain Real Estate.
The free iHeartRadio app has over 100 commercial-free stations waiting for you to explore right now, like Freeform Radio, a unique blend of Americana, classic alternative, and roots rock. iHeartRadio app, search Freeform Radio, and listen now, commercial free. Free never sounded so good.
From the Cool Today Weather Center, cooltoday.com.
Mostly cloudy today, slight chance of showers, more likely in the afternoon, our high 83. Overnight, a better chance of showers, 70% chance. Our low will drop back to 71. Tomorrow, more of the same. Mostly cloudy in the morning. Slight chance of showers and thunderstorms. About a 70% chance, actually, in the morning. And then sunny in the afternoon. Our high right around 76.
This report is sponsored by Rasmussen University.
I had so many dreams, but life quickly got in the way. Then Rasmussen University saw my true potential and gave me the support and confidence I needed to become who I am today.
Rasmussen University. Learn more at rasmussen.edu/Florida.
This is WDAE on air and streaming live right now on the free iHeartRadio app. Download it now.
Pan Aaron 95.3 WDAE and AM 620, 888-546-4620 for your chance to win a four-pack of tickets to see your Tampa Bay Rays take on the Blue Jays on Friday at Tropicana Field. 6:50, first pitch. 888-546-4620 for your chance to win. We'll have some Todd Bowles audio in a few minutes as well, as he was talking yesterday at the NFL owners meeting. We'll get into some of the big news about some of the new rules coming up in the show about that have broke at the NFL owners meeting. One of the biggest changes we've ever seen in our lifetime.
People were very vocal about it yesterday, too.
Did you see angry people about it?
Yeah, I saw a couple angry people about it. Not too many, though.
Everyone I love it.
Seemed pretty fine. And by the way, once we get used to it, everyone will probably love it, too.
Yeah.
And then it will be a thing of the past. Kids will be like, I don't even remember the old rule.
I already see the promotion coming. Who's going to the Hall of Fame this year? Devin Hester, and all of a sudden kickoffs are back. What a
Don't tell Casey Warner.
What a promotion.
Casey Warner loves a good special teams.
Well, it's wonderful. All right, 888-546-4620 if you want to win your way in to see the Rays and Jays on Friday. Ray is in Carrollwood. Ray, good morning.
Dre in Carrollwood.
Dre, sorry about that. Casey got it wrong on the call
Casey
screen.
Casey makes you Ray. You're Ray.
Yeah, oh, wow. Yeah, you're officially Ray now. Hey,
Casey's got power.
Ray, either way, you'll be happy if you're going to the Rays game on Friday. We told you earlier in the show, if you've been listening, yesterday a fantastic performance from Ryan Pepiot, who went six innings for the Rays in his spring finale. Which former Rays pitcher pitched the final three innings of the game for the Rays?
It sounded weird.
I know.
God.
All right, so sorry, Dre. I think he effed it too.
I think he effed it.
Yeah,
too.
I hit the button
Good.
For the record.
Good
I did.
Man.
I did dump him.
Nice.
888-546-4620 Ben,
don't be upset enough to drop an F bomb if you don't get it right. Like, it's not life or death.
Ben in West Chase. Ben, good morning.
Morning, gentlemen. How we doing?
We are well. Which former Rays pitcher pitched the final three innings for the Rays yesterday after Ryan Pepiot went the first six?
Yeah, well, he started good in that first inning, and then he kind of got a little shaky, but it was Jake Odorizzi.
Yeah, it was, Ben. You will be heading to see the Rays on Friday. Hold on. Just hold until the break so Casey can get your information, and you're heading on Friday to see the Rays and Jays in Game 2 of the MLB season.
Should I do a Freaky Five this week?
Like a baseball Freaky Five? You could do the tournament.
That's what I'm thinking. If we start it today, we can start it today or do it tomorrow.
I would say today, because tomorrow will be at the Trop for opening day. It's going to be very baseball.
Not that
we won't mention the Sweet 16, but I would say we should, if we're going to Freaky Five, we should Freaky Five today.
I did Crazy 10 last week, and I came really close to a $3,500 banger.
That is crazy.
I think I'm going to go back to the Freaky Five for this week. Okay. So we'll do baseball or Sweet 16, whatever you want to do. Freaky Five, 888-546-4620.
No hockey?
Or basketball or hockey. I'll take
it
all.
We got Bolts Bruins tonight, baby.
Yeah, well, if we're going to build it, then we got to finish it out today. That Freaky Five today.
I think we should try to finish it out today because of the fact that you are, you know, I'm saying we'll be at the Trop tomorrow.
And if you never heard of the Freaky Five, it's five picks, listeners, first five callers. I have to go with whatever pick they give me. 888-546-4620. Give me winners.
All right. Let's go to a little bit of Buccaneer talk, as I mentioned before the break. And listen, a lot of us loved Baker Mayfield this season and what he was able to do for this team. But at the same time, realize that he's going to need to be better if he's going to be a franchise quarterback, if this team is going to go the places we want to see it go again. And Todd Bowles spoke yesterday at the NFL owners meetings about one of the things or what Baker is going to need to do better this upcoming season. Jeez.
There's always little things. There's still the grasp of the offense. Obviously, from Dave to Liam calling plays, you have to get a better feel. Even though they've been together, they haven't been together like this, starting from scratch for a full year. Just take command of the offense and making the adjustments. And he did that last year, but there's still some nuances we can get better at, and he'll be the first to tell you that. Some nuances he can get better at to make us more efficient. Would like him to slide a little bit more when he can. Don't want to take away none of his competitiveness, but just commanding the offense and getting us in great positions and putting the ball where it needs to be. And just continue to do that.
Of course you want your quarterback to slide, but how many times did we need him to not slide to extend a possession? And that's the why we fell in love with Baker, but it's also why he's one hit away from us trying to fall in love with a backup quarterback.
Yeah, no, you love it when he has the grittiness, but there are definitely times that Todd is right and he needs to do that. So interesting, because I think a lot of people would probably suggest that Todd Bowles wouldn't know that there are nuances to the offense that Baker still needs to get better at. So I think every now and then he doesn't get his hands in the offense because he likes to let his offensive guys do their thing. But I think he knows more about the offensive side of the ball than people think.
When you're a defensive genius, when your mind is scheming defensively all the time, you're going up and scheming against offenses. So Todd Bowles knows what an offense and a good offense looks like and how to stop a good offense. So that way he uses his mind to say, this is what I would like to see you do. That way, listen, when we're talking about sliding, you don't have to be a genius to not want your quarterback to get hurt. And him being a defensive guy.
But that's not what he's talking about when he says nuances
offense. For sure. Absolutely. He wasn't very descriptive with the nuances. So you don't know if that's coming from, his discussions with Liam Cohen, moving forward here. But also, like I said, he schemes against offenses. He knows what a good offense is supposed to look like.
Now, what's interesting to me is a year ago, if Todd Bowles said he was more comfortable than he had been the previous year, I'd go, well, yeah, of course. The previous year, you were handed a team. You were handed all these things. You didn't have any impact on the roster. You didn't have any impact on the coaching staff. I understand why last year he would have been much more comfortable than a season before. A little surprised to hear him say he's more comfortable this year than even last year.
I feel more comfortable because we have a solid quarterback that's played. You know, after Tom left, we didn't really have a guy that's played any snaps that stepped up in there. But having gone through a year with him, knowing we have a quarterback at that position and it's solidified, you feel more comfortable that way. But we still got to win games.
Oh, poor Kyle Trask. He's not right. I mean, obviously Kyle knows he's never played in this league, really.
Yeah.
So, but he didn't have a quarterback.
Last thing I want to get to is something we've been very excited about, obviously, and we found out when the news was leaked by, I almost said Jamel Dean, but it was Dee Delaney, who sort of leaked the news on Twitter. But we've always been very excited since we found out that Jordan Whitehead would indeed be returning. And Todd talked about that yesterday as well.
We'll have a lot more communication. You know, Jordan was great when he was here before. He was a great communicator and leader for us when he was on the field. Him and Levante clicked a couple years ago, and I'm sure Levante is one of the happiest guys to have him back. I'm happy to have him back. And Winfield, the whole team is happy to have him back in the fold, and just look forward to with the experience that he's gotten in New York to help us get better on the back end.
I'll play Shohei's translator. Ryan Neal, you are bad at communicating.
You know what? We didn't make our predictions for the Rays as far as win totals.
7 o'clock hour?
That's what we're going to do. Let's do coming it. Up next. That and we'll get into a lot as we're just a day away from opening day and an hour away from Doug Wechter joining the show on a Wechter Wednesday on the Pat and Aaron Show on 95.3 WDAE and AM 620.
Tomorrow is opening day. Join WDAE live from Tropicana Field as we stay live and local from the sunrise to first pitch of the home slate. On the radio home of the Tampa Bay Rays, 95.3 WDAE and AM 620. Streaming live on Alexa and the free iHeartRadio app. Presented by the Central Florida Behavioral Health Network and the Department of Children and Families.
This March, it's time to join the winning team for your home loan needs with HowardTeamHomeLoans.com. Right now, homeowners' debt is madness with credit card rates going through the roof. It's time to march into savings with Howard Team Home Loans and see what options work best for you. John and his team can coach you on your individual needs, so it's time to break away from high interest rates and get off the bench and experience the slam dunk of a deal with home loans by getting started today at HowardTeamHomeLoans.com.
Lower LLC, NMLS, 1124061. Equal housing opportunity, terms and conditions.
This is a special alert to all Americans who own a vehicle with less than 200,000 miles with an auto warranty about to expire or with no warranty coverage at all. Due to a decline in the economy, CarShield is announcing a low-cost, month-to-month vehicle protection plan that is now available to the public to save any driver out-of-pocket expenses on future auto repairs. Call now to find out how you can pay almost nothing for covered auto repairs. Yes, you heard that correctly. Pay almost nothing for covered auto repairs. An open phone line has been established for all drivers to call for a free quick quote. Call 800-326-7765 now. Drivers who are covered will not have to pay for covered repairs again. This protection plan is at an all-time low. Additionally, drivers who activate this vehicle protection today will also receive free roadside assistance, free towing, and car rental options at no additional cost. Call us for your free quick quote today. 800-326-7765. That's 800-326-7765. What do you have to lose? Call 800-326-7765. Again, 800-326-7765.
Aaron Jacobson here, and spring has officially sprung for the used car market, and you know what that means? Full tilt boogie time at GiveMeTheVIN.com. Looking to sell your car, truck, or SUV? GiveMeTheVIN.com. They make selling your vehicle fast and easy, and that's all we want in this world, for things to be simple. GiveMeTheVIN.com. They're A-plus rated by the BBB for a reason. Go check them out. When you log on to GiveMeTheVIN.com, you're going to see why satisfied customers across the country, they're putting more money in their pocket by just going to GiveMeTheVIN.com. They want to buy your vehicle right now. So go to GiveMeTheVIN.com, put in your VIN number, a few pictures, and get ready. Yes, it is just that easy. If GiveMeTheVIN.com can't beat your CarMax offer, they'll pay you $100, period, just like that. So check them out. Log on to GiveMeTheVIN.com, put in your VIN or license number, a couple pictures, and get that instant cash offer. 60-second bid process, pressure-free service, and free pickup. GiveMeTheVIN.com and get your check on the spot.
Hey, you got any gum?
Yeah. Check my backpack.
What's this?
Oh, that's naloxone. It can reverse an opioid overdose. I decided to always keep it on me after my friend almost died. It saved his life.
Oh, wow. I'm so sorry. That makes me want to have it with me, too.
You totally should. Check the pharmacy. It was actually really easy to get, and it's easy to use.
I definitely will. Thanks.
Naloxone saves lives. Learn more at cdc.gov/stopoverdose.
Hi, I'm Jade, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A sausage, egg, and cheese biscuit is the savoriness of the sausage, the fluffiness of the egg, and the butteriness of the biscuit. It's amazing. The perfect start to my day.
Hi, everyone. It's Justin. A little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A sausage, egg, and cheese biscuit is the fluffy egg, the melted cheese, and the sizzling sausage. It's the start to your morning that you didn't know you need.
Order a sausage, egg, and cheese biscuit and Simply Orange Juice on the Chick-fil-A app. Real guests paid for their testimonials.
The tournament is here. Bet Online is your bracket headquarters for this season with the best bracket contest out there and odds, lines, and info on every game and every round right up until the national championship. You can access the most up-to-the-minute wagering information anytime from your desktop or your mobile device and even track your bracket real-time all the way through the tournament. Head to Bet Online today to stay updated on all the action. Bet Online. The game starts here.
Stuck in traffic? Signal cutting out? Get online. Download the free iHeartRadio app. You can take WDAE and your home for sports, music, talk, and podcasts all in one app. Free never sounded so good. Presented by the law offices of Anajar and Levine, accident attorneys. Call 1-800-747-FREE.
That's 1-800-747-3733.
Broadcasting from the Rude Air Conditioning Studios. This is Tampa Bay's home for the best Bolts coverage all season long. We are 620 WTAE St. Petersburg, 95.3 FM W237 CW Pinellas Park, 95.7 HD3 WBTP Clearwater, 96.7 FM W224 BE Brandon. Streaming live on the free iHeartRadio app. Listen for all your music, sports, talk, and podcasts. Free never sounded so good.
I like this kind of party.
Putting the fun in dysfunctional.
Yeah!
Each and every weekday morning, the Pat and Aaron Show.
Is this a little too early for being that loud?
Good morning, Tampa Bay.
And here we go.
Now your hosts, Pat Donovan and Aaron Jacobson.
Good morning, goons. One day away from opening day baseball. We'll be at the Trop all day long, from sunrise to first pitch and through the game, right here on WDAE. Make sure you're carrying us wherever you go on your smartphones. It's free. Download the Pat and Aaron Show. Download 95.3 WDAE and AM 620, because we got opening day, Rays baseball. We've got Sweet 16 action tomorrow and Friday night. We've got Doug Wechter in studio today, and then we're heading to the Hard Rock. You and I are going to be there. Ronnie and T-Kraz, of course, doing their final show together. The final Ronnie and T-Kraz show, yes. After a decade, they are doing their final show today at the Hard Rock, so come on down. It's going to be at the L Bar, correct?
Correct, yeah.
Well, it's going to be at the L Bar.
Yeah, the L Bar, as you like to do.
Yeah, if you watch on YouTube, Twitch, Facebook, WDAE, I'm dropping L bombs here. It's going to be at the L Bar, and I'm really excited for today. I'm really excited to go down there and meet some listeners, but also bid farewell to our good friends Ronnie and T-Kraz, at least for their show together.
I think there's a specific drink at the L Bar that Ronnie really likes.
You get whatever Ronnie likes.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. We got to go celebrate Ronnie with whatever he's drinking.
Can't wait to see Bobby, his lovely wife, who I know will be there. So we're going to have a lot of fun today, and we're certainly going to be celebrating.
I don't think they're leaving. Ronnie was telling me, like, we're getting a room. Like, we're staying. We're partying.
Smart man. He's one of the guys. He is one of the coolest guys, if not the coolest, in the Bay Area. So excited to celebrate that later. And then today, we are gearing up for first pitch tomorrow. We're going to give our predictions. Prediction time for the season for the Tampa Bay Rays. And just keep in mind, before we give our predictions, and we'll take your predictions, we've been taking them all morning long on the text line. Just text your predictions to 82945, starting with DAE. This team is already riddled with injuries. And we're not just talking about the rotation where they came into the season hampered. We're talking about Josh Lowe. We're talking about...
Which is huge to me.
Yeah, we're talking about guys that we expected to come in here like Josh Lowe and produce right away.
What I hate about the Josh Lowe injury, Aaron, is the fact that it's his hip, and I just... For a guy that young to have a hip problem is scary because it makes you worry about longevity, but B, just even within this season, it just seemed like a hip problem is the thing that bounces back and forth, and they never really go away, kind of like a shoulder, you know?
Yep, and Johnny DeLuca is a guy we expected to provide some depth for this team, some speed for this team, came over in the Glasnow trade with Ryan Pepio. Of course, Manny Margot is traded in that deal. He's since moved on but from the Dodgers, but now we've got... You know, him dealing with a broken hand. You've got Taj Bradley for the rotation going down. Jonathan Aranda, who is supposed to play a valuable role for this team and hopefully try to find his way in Major League Baseball with the Rays finally in regular season action. He's going to start the season, miss at least 4 to 6 weeks. He's got that pin in his finger. And that he hurt his hand taking infield. This is not good to start the season, but still, there's something in me that has blind faith that they have built enough depth with this team that they'll figure it out.
I hope so. You know, when it comes to Aranda, you know, there's been a lot of speculation. The Rays might try to move on from Harold Ramirez. And that's a guy that, you know, Aranda, they need him to kind of be able to step into that role in a major way, I think, if they're going to be able to do that. And I'll be honest with you, I don't really want them to do that.
We went from Ramirez is going to be leaving this team to we probably need Ramirez to help out in right field. That's where we're at. We were told all offseason long Ramirez is probably going to be with a new team. And now we're so hampered that he's probably going to need to help out in right field.
I hope it's not a lot. I hope it's not a lot either because, I mean, he's a better athlete than he might look like. He's a big, thick dude. You know what I mean? But, like, you see him on the base paths. He can move. But I'd rather he be able to focus on hitting because he is such an important part of this lineup that, to me, putting him out in the outfield is just a risk. We can't afford.
So Rays predictions on the text line, 82945, starting with DAE. The rotation is set. It's going to be Eflin, Savale, Littell, Tyler Alexander, and Pepio is going to be the fifth in the rotation. I expect that to change a lot throughout the season. But with all being said, you look at last year, close to 100 wins. You look at the prior year, under 90 wins. I think they're going to be somewhere in between that myself. I think they're going to be around 90. I'm going to finish my prediction optimistic. I'm going to say the Rays get 92 wins this season.
That is optimistic. And again, I predicted, I think, that 101 wins last year after the season before went pretty well. But I'm going to go with 88 wins. I think this is, I don't think they're below 500 team. I know a lot of people think they're right around 500, maybe a little below. I think somebody texted in 84.5 was the over-under.
I'm going to check it right now.
I was just going to say we should take a look at the Hard Rock Sportsbook app. What are you going to do if somebody wants that as part of your Freaky Five?
I will not do the long play.
No long plays.
No, give me something for this week. I'm not doing darts.
I did $50 on the Bucks, but, you know.
That's you. On the text line, Rays will go 17-0 or 10-6. A Buccaneer John record, if I've ever seen one.
Oh, that's amazing.
Table tennis on right now.
Oh, don't.
Should I?
No.
Get me pumped?
No.
I'm trying to build up something for Vegas.
That's not how you do it. But why? Because you're going to take the money that's in your Hard Rock app and use it in Vegas?
No, I withdraw it. Like last week when I won big, I put it right into my card. I withdrew. Zandecki's plus 500 right now.
How much are you going to put on table tennis?
$5, build it up. I don't know.
And then you're going to pull, what, you say plus 500? So what's that? 25
bucks, and then
you
25
pull that out of your app
50.
For Vegas.
No, then I turn it around. I'm building up. I got a couple days. I got Thursday Sweet 16 games and all of opening day. What's wrong with you? Team futures, the Rays, let's go to regular season record. Oh my gosh, this is, there's so many teams. Over or under 84.5. Yeah, they had it right. 84.5.
I still think that's low. As pessimistic as I am, because I don't know if I'm pessimistic. I feel like I'm realistic because I'm usually so confident in this team. I mean, like I said, 101 last year, over 90-something the year before as far as predictions. I believe in what this organization does so much. I just look at this as kind of one of those years that you're missing so many key pieces that you know you're going to have back next year. I think you're kind of punting the year a little bit. I hate to say it.
So I'm at 92. Write it down, Casey Warner. You're at 88. Mm. Skippy the Goon on the text line, or Skip. I'm not sure if that's Skippy the Goon. 85 wins from Skip.
If they get exactly 85, it's going to suck so hard for the people who play the over. Because you're going to be waiting until the last minute.
That's fun. Where really you could have just, where that's so funny, because if you would have just done that, you could have just bet the last game of the season, like for the Rays to win. You could have waited all season, just waited, but nobody knows how it's going to play out. Somebody else from the 813 has an 85 win total, taking the postseason off this year on the text line. That's no good. Casey Warner, where do you come into play? Where is your prediction? Are you 17-0 guy?
17-0 guy. Personally, I think I'm going to go in between you all. I was thinking about this before I even heard y'all's over under, but 89 seems like a nice little midpoint.
Seems fair.
So I'm going to go 89. I don't think they're going to have as hot of a start. And I think
No. There's no chance they have as hot of a start.
So even close though, like I don't think they even start out the year with a winning record.
I think it's
going to be very tough starting out, but I think they hit stride at a later point this season and end up going, you know, getting hot before the playoffs. That's what I think.
Last year, if you wanted to be in the playoffs, you had to get 89 wins in the American League. So the Blue Jays snuck into that wild card, that final wild card spot with 89 wins. The Rangers, who went on to win the World Series, 90 wins last year. So 90 wins. We had teams last year. The Rays had 99 wins last year and did not win the division. All right, so it just shows you how tough the AL East is.
And remember, again, how they started.
And it also shows you a team like the Rangers, you get hot at the right time, you get in the playoffs, doesn't matter where your positioning is, playing game or not, and you can make a run and win it. So just get to the playoffs.
You want to talk about a difference between the American League and the National League? I predicted the Rays would win 88 games this season, right? That would have had the third most victories, and I'm sorry, fourth. The fourth most victories in all of the National, fifth most victories in all the National League. But still, it would have been good enough to make the playoffs. And by the way, the Arizona Diamondbacks, who were in the World Series, won 84 games last season.
Which is wild. But to your point, kind of.
point? Why did I snort?
They would have been in the same position last year. They would have been in the top of the wild card spot. The exact same position. But the Marlins got in at 84 with 84 wins. So if the Braves were in the National League last year, the Diamondbacks wouldn't have made the playoff.
Yeah.
The Diamondbacks wouldn't have made the playoffs. It would have been Rays, Phillies, and Marlins, and the Diamondbacks would have never made that run. Baseball's weird, man.
I would not be surprised, Aaron. You look back, just looking back at last year's standings, right? The Rays, second place. I wouldn't be surprised if the division plays out exactly the same, but there is a much tighter gap between the Rays, Blue Jays, and Yankees than there was last year.
It's just amazing what the Orioles have done, where they're not up and coming. They're here right now. They're a team that is a division winner, and they look like they're ready to do it again.
Heavy favorites, right? I'm not even talking about odds. For you. Forget about the odds. Don't even look at the odds.
I have to look at the odds.
No, for you, in your mind, are they heavy favorites to win the division?
No.
To win the division?
No.
I think they are.
No.
Who is
it's such a good division that I don't say anybody is a heavy favorite in the American League East. It's really hard to do that.
You know what? When the Rays started the way they did last year and still couldn't win the division against that Baltimore team, and Baltimore, to me, got better as much as anybody in the division this offseason, I think they are heavy. In my mind, they are the heavy favorite.
In the Hard Rock app, they're not even the favorite to win the division.
Who is?
Who do you think is?
I don't know.
Take
Toronto?
Nope.
Us?
the Yankees.
That's stupid. I'm sorry.
Here are the odds.
That is so stupid.
American League East winner in the Hard Rock Bet app. The Yankees are the favorite at plus 170. The Orioles second at plus 190. The Blue Jays in third at plus 400. The Rays in fourth plus 650. And the Red Sox in the cellar at plus 1750. I don't remember the last time the Rays or the Red Sox were that. People were that down on the Red Sox and all the sharps in Vegas. When Vegas has, this scares me. And I know Vegas isn't the end all be all. When they got the Rays finishing fourth, when they got odds for them to win the division at pretty bad, when they've got 84.5 wins as a win total, usually Vegas is, I mean, they're not always on, but they know things. They drink and they know things.
Yeah.
Oh, man. All right. Well, listen, we're going to continue talking about this. We'll take your predictions on the text line, 82945. Start your text with DAE. And then on the other side, the NFL. They've decided to make one of the biggest changes to the game we've seen really in our lifetime. We'll tell you what it is and whether it's a good idea and what the rules origin says about the NFL. The rule change, what it says about the NFL. We'll talk about that on the other side.
WDAE.
Traffic update.
Southbound 275 now on the brakes south of Fowler Avenue towards Hillsboro and downtown Tampa. And we're seeing delays on westbound I-4 near Branch Forbes and through Ybor City from before 22nd Street to 275. Crash in Tampa southbound Anderson near Limbaugh and building traffic on the southbound Veterans Expressway approaching the Courtney Campbell Causeway and the airport. With traffic, I'm Randy Myers.
This report is sponsored by Fresh from Florida.
Meal planning is work, so let Fresh from Florida help. Learn what's in season, browse hundreds of recipes, and get tips from Chef Justin by visiting freshfromflorida.com. Eat healthier with Fresh from Florida. There's sunshine in every bite.
The best live thoroughbred racing around. It is at Tampa Bay Downs. Easy to get to right in our backyard. And on Wednesdays, it is free. And then Fridays, Saturdays, and Sundays, it's only $3. Gates open at 11 a.m. Post time for the first race, 12:15. You can get your programs there at the program stands for $2.25. It's easy. You get informed by reading those programs. A race day program, it's going to show you all the information you need. So for the bettors out there, the inexperienced bettors, that's going to help you out. Plus, they've got tip sheets for the inexperienced bettors, so you can make some good bets and potentially win some big money. Always great things happening at Tampa Bay Downs. April 7th from 12 to 3, you're going to have the entire family having some great times out there on the track. Everyone's going to get to meet the track mascot, Mouse the Miniature Horse, and also the kids can enjoy the pony rides, bounce houses, a variety of games, all these great activities. April 7th, 12 to 3, only at Tampa Bay Downs. Check them out online, TampaBayDowns.com. That's TampaBayDowns.com.
Prescriptions require an online consultation with a healthcare provider who will determine if appropriate. Restrictions apply. See website for details and important safety information. Subscription required. Price varies based on product and subscription plan.
Hey guys, did you know there's a generic form of Viagra that works just the same but is 95% cheaper? And you can get it online at hims.com/joy. Through Hims, you'll get a free medical consultation to determine the ED medication that's best for you. Discreet shipping if prescribed, a 100% online process, and a range of treatment options, including trusted generic alternatives to the name brands, at up to 95% off. ED is personal, and at Hims, so is treating it. Just go to hims.com/joy and get connected to a licensed medical provider online for free. With zero copay, no expensive appointments, and no awkward face-to-face conversations. To start your free online visit, you need to go to this exclusive address, hims.com/joy. That's hims.com/joy for your free online visit, hims.com/joy.
Ew, gotta get rid of this old Backstreet Boys t-shirt.
Tell me why.
Because it stinks, boys.
Tell me why.
I've washed it so many times, but the odor won't come out.
Tell me why.
No, you tell me why I can't get rid of this odor.
Have you tried Downy Rinse and Refresh? It doesn't just cover up odors. It helps remove them.
Wow, it worked, guys.
Yeah.
Downy Rinse and Refresh removes more odor in one wash than the leading value detergent in three washes. Find it wherever you buy laundry products.
Tampa Golfers, Global Golf Outlet is now open with the largest selection of used clubs in Florida. You'll find thousands of used name brand clubs to choose from, all at one location. TaylorMade, Callaway, Titleist, Ping, Cleveland, and more, all at incredible prices. And at Global Golf Outlet, you'll also find hundreds of closeout deals on bags, shoes, and apparel. It's Florida's largest and only golf outlet where you can try, buy, and and trade all in one place. Global Golf Outlet, located on Gunn Highway in the Hampton Plaza.
For more information about contests on this station, go to 953wdae.com/rules.
The free iHeartRadio app has over 100 commercial-free stations waiting for you to explore right now, like Freeform Radio. A unique blend of Americana, classic alternative, and roots rock. Open the free iHeartRadio app, search Freeform Radio, and listen now, commercial free. Free never sounded so good.
This report is sponsored by Lowe's. Save big during MVP's bonus days at Lowe's. Buy one select DeWalt 20V Max tool, get one DeWalt 20V Max Power Stack battery 2-pack free, a $179 value. Valid 318 through 329 while supplies last. Selection varies by location.
Mostly cloudy today. Slight chance of showers, more likely in the afternoon. Our high 83. Overnight, a better chance of showers, 70% chance. Our low will drop back to 71. Tomorrow, more of the same. Mostly cloudy in the morning. Slight chance of showers and thunderstorms. About a 70% chance, actually, in the morning. And then sunny in the afternoon. Our high right around 76.
Running to a meeting or just need to get away? No problem. Download the free iHeartRadio app, where you can take WDAE and your home for sports, music, talk, and podcasts all in one app. Free never sounded so good. Presented by the law offices of Anajar and Levine, accident attorneys. Call 1-800-747-FREE.
That's 1-800-747-3733.
NFL rule changes. Every year we see a couple rule changes, especially the last couple years. It seems like we've had some significant rule changes. But this year, maybe the biggest rule change of them all, the new kickoff rule. Now, we've talked about it before. And the way the kickoff rule in the XFL went is really what they're going to be adopting right now. It's a dramatic rule change, proposing kickoff changes like this and it passing, and it did.
Whether or not it's the biggest rule change of our lifetime, it's definitely going to be the most noticeable.
Yes, and here's what's going on, and this is what you need to know about this. The new rule, it's going to be given a one-year trial run. So if this doesn't work out, if this doesn't pass the test, then they can run it back to the way it used to be. So the new rule has been approved, but if they don't like the way it works, it's not going to stick around.
I think it is.
I do too. Because the point of it is to diminish the risk of injury, and it's exactly what it does.
And to basically bring back the kickoff, right? Because it was almost non-existent. Now, it's interesting what they're doing with onside kicks, because basically now you have to tell people if you're going to do an onside kick. They won't allow a surprise onside kick at all. That's kind of weird.
It's weird. But it's insane, but I don't see a lot of people. They weren't successfully converting them anyway.
Yeah.
I don't see them being able to do it much now when you have to let them know what you're doing unless you get a lucky bounce.
And I think we'll eventually see them do something with that rule as well. But what I love about this, Aaron, is I think you might remember when we started talking about this, we both agreed that this made a lot of sense and might be a really good idea for the NFL to adopt. But what I said at the time was, I don't know if the NFL will, because I don't know if the NFL is going to want to look like that they're adopting things from the XFL. I'm glad that they're not too closed-minded. I'm glad that they're not like that, the ego isn't like, well, we're the NFL and we do everything right. And of course, nobody can do anything better than us. I'm glad that they are willing to adopt rules from outside the league to make the game better. I think it's a really good sign.
The NFL owners, they didn't unanimously pass this. They didn't unanimously pass this. Three teams voted against the proposal. Those three teams, the Raiders, the 49ers, and the Packers.
I'm pretty sure, and this has been a long-standing tradition since Al Davis, pretty sure the Raiders vote against everything themselves did not put forth. And I think they might bet against their own stuff sometimes just to be the Raiders.
I like that. I like the mindset. I really do. Under the new rule, 21 of the 22 players on the field will be lining up in the receiving team's territory. Only the kicker is going to be in the kicking team's territory. So The entire proposal was 9.5 pages long. That's a lot to digest.
That is.
I don't know what you could, in the new rules, how many things you would need to fill up 9.5 pages.
Also, name the zones. Yeah, you can't. You know why? Because none of us can.
It's
so much new stuff. It's like, these players will be lined up in the landing zone.
Casey can. All right, do it, Casey.
All right, so we got the kickoff zone.
Look at us.
Zone.
Straight up.
The return zone, the touchback zone, and the receiving zone?
Nope. Yes, you already messed one. You already messed one of them up.
Yeah,
I got
three of them, though.
So confident.
Nah, he was pretty good.
Hey, by the way, I hope you all heard it on the way in. Chris Canty said that Matthew Slater's a Hall of Famer. So,
no.
Thank you. Former NFL player right there.
Did he? Find me that audio.
Sure did.
Find me that audio.
I'll try to find it. I mean, it's...
Pictures or it didn't happen.
ESPN Radio or whatever. So, yeah, I can go back and find it.
Yeah,
I'll find it or it didn't happen.
Listen, I'm not going to criticize Chris Canty for getting high.
I'll criticize you for getting high.
There you go. So there's a lot of pages here, a lot of things to digest. But the thing you need to know is they're going to be making this change, and you're going to see a very different looking formation on the kickoff return. If it works, great. It will be used in the future. If it doesn't, it will end after one season.
And you're going to see actual kickoff returns this year. I think it's going to be exciting. I'm very happy that they made this move, and I'm excited to see how it works out.
Some of the other rule changes yesterday. Trade deadline got moved. The deadline used to be the first Tuesday after week 8, but now it's going to be the first Tuesday after week 9, which means it will be on November 5th this year, which that's election day.
Which, by the way, puts it at about the same part in the season-ish, because the season's a week longer now, too.
Reviewable plays involving the quarterback. A play can now be reviewed to make sure a QB got a pass off before being downed or pushed out of bounds. So that one's interesting. That's going to be to use with, they can assist that on intentional grounding.
Also, I love intentional grounding. They can check if the quarterback's been outside the pocket. Also, all these stupid, quarterback penalties that we're seeing, like roughing the passer, the replay official can now go back and determine that a quarterback was not hit in the head and remove that flag as well, which I think is fantastic. I love that change as well.
Yeah, there's a couple of them I really like. The NFL can now review the game clock. Officials are now allowed to review whether a snap got off before the clock reaches zero. There are so many times where we see that where it's like, wait, we've looked on the clock. It was on zero for at least a second. So why was that not called delay a game or something?
Also, a significant change when it comes to the challenge replay system. If you get, it used to be you'd have to get your first two challenges right to be awarded a third challenge. Now, if you get either of the first two right, you only have to get one right. You are then awarded a third challenge.
So a lot of rule changes, and I think most of them are pretty good. As we saw, wasn't unanimously passed by the NFL owners, but only three naysayers, the Raiders, the 49ers, and the Packers.
And the Raiders barely count.
There you go. The Raiders barely count. They do it all the time. On the other side, what kind of baseball fan are you? What kind of Rays fan are you? Can you be patient through a bumpy 2024? We'll get into the Rays and what their season's going to look like. And Charlie, you're going to lead us off on the other side. Hang tight. I appreciate you. He's got a Freaky Five. He's going to kick off the Freaky Five. I'm building a monster parlay here. I need your help. 888-546-4620. The first five picks, the first five callers give me, I got to roll with them on the Hard Rock Bet app. That's next.
Live from the Seminole Hard Rock Hotel and Casino. Don't miss out on the ultimate celebration. Today at 3 p.m. will mark the grand finale of the legendary Ronnie and T-Crash show on WDAE. Join us as we bid farewell to this dynamic duo in style. It's the last hurrah, the final word, and literally the end of an era. Tune in starting at 3 p.m. to catch all the excitement on 95.3 WDAE and AM 620. Let's send Ronnie and T-Crash off with a bang as we salute their incredible run since 2014 on Tampa Bay's favorite sports radio station, 95.3 WDAE and AM 620.
That's right. We're all going to be out at the Hard Rock today. And if you come out and you're there, I don't know when he's getting there, but I know if you're there at the end of the show, he's going to be there for a toast, our friend John Mamola. You might look, if you've met John Mamola before and you come out today, you might look at John Mamola and go, hey, dude, where's the rest of you? Because John Mamola has lost a ton of weight with our friends at Age Rejuvenation. I'm doing it a little more gradually. I'm just going with diet and exercise, but John wanted to lose weight a little quicker. And he's using their semaglutide program, which is really giving him a boost, and he's doing a great job. If you're thinking about losing weight, you know it's time. I waited too long. John probably waited too long. A lot of us do. Stop waiting. Get it done. Ask John how much better he feels if you see him tonight. It's night and day. And it's night and day for me as well. All you have to do is go to agerejuvenation.com. Again, whether you want that boost of the semaglutide program or you want to do things a little more gradually and just do them with diet and exercise, Age Rejuvenation can build the perfect weight loss program for you. Go to agerejuvenation.com. Tell them I sent you. They'll give you 50% off your first month.
Some days I cover up because of my moderate to severe plaque psoriasis. Now I'm hitting the road with clearer skin thanks to Skyrizi, Risankizumab Riza, a prescription-only 150 milligram injection for adults who are candidates for systemic or phototherapy. With Skyrizi, 3 out of 4 people achieved 90% clearer skin at 4 months. And Skyrizi is just 4 doses a year after 2 starter doses.
Don't use if allergic to Skyrizi. Serious allergic reactions and an increased risk of infections or a lower ability to fight them may occur. Before treatment, your doctor should check for infection and tuberculosis. Tell your doctor if you have an infection or symptoms, such as fever, sweats, chills, muscle aches, or cough, or if you plan to or recently received a vaccine.
Thanks to Skyrizi, there's nothing on my skin, and that means everything. Your doctor today about Skyrizi, the number one dermatologist prescribed biologic in psoriasis, and visit skyrizi.com or call 1-866-SKYRIZI to learn more.
What's the Anajar Levine difference? When you're injured in a car crash, we focus on your case so you can focus on the one thing that matters most, getting better. I'm Glenn Levine with Anajar Levine. We'll fight to get you the maximum compensation you deserve. Call our legal team right now for a free consultation. 1-800-747-FREE. We'll help you take back control of your life. Call 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
Main office, Tampa.
We're going abroad for the first time in years. To Spain. So we started using Babbel.
And started learning Spanish fast.
With Babbel, you can start having conversations in another language in just 3 weeks.
¿Cómo te llamas?
¿Cómo te llamas?
When you learn a language, you want to actually use it. Babbel is designed with that goal in mind.
In just 3 weeks, we're starting to have conversations in Spanish. Gracias, Babbel.
Babbel, language for life. Now try Babbel for free at Babbel.com. That's Babbel.com.
Some things in life you can just rely on, like the faithful friend who always comes when you call, your fishing buddies, and the tried and true performance of a new Rude Home AC system. So here's to reliability built into everything we do. Rely on Rude. Get reliable cooling and comfort installed by a certified Rude Pro Partner. Go to RudeACFlorida.com to schedule service with a Rude Pro Partner today. That's RudeACFlorida.com. Powered locally by Ferguson HVAC.
Plumbing, HVAC, and electrical contractors on Service Titan put up big numbers. How big? In their first 2 years on Service Titan, contractors typically see a 10% increase in call booking rates, a 9% increase in average ticket size, and a 17% increase in revenue. They also average a 4.7 out of 5 stars on customer review sites. Add it all up and the answer is clear. When solving for profitability, productivity, and growth, Service Titan is an essential part of the equation for contractors like you. Learn more today at ServiceTitan.com. That's ServiceTitan.com. Individual results may vary.
This Easter weekend, hop on over to Pool Perfection's grand opening of their second location. With 20 years of experience and top-notch quality, they're bringing the best to North Tampa communities. Just 2 miles west of the Tampa Premium Outlets on State Road 54. Join the festivities this Saturday, 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. and Sunday from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. Indulge in delicious food and exciting fun as you explore what Pool Perfection has to offer. Plus, for those attending, there are fantastic incentives in store if you're considering building that pool. Don't miss out on the treats this weekend. Come celebrate with Pool Perfection.
Sponsored by Howard Team, homeloans.com.
The free iHeartRadio app has over 100 commercial free stations like Freeform Radio. Search Freeform Radio and listen now on your free iHeartRadio app. Free never sounded so good.
Broadcasting from the Rude Air Conditioning Studios, this is Tampa Bay Sports Radio, 95.3 WDAE and AM 620.
103, 1, 2, 3.
Home of the best box coverage.
All right, I'm excited. I've been excited all morning, but we got Doug Wechter coming in studio at 8 o'clock. 7:30 right now. Welcome to the show if you're just joining us.
Pat, I can smell Aaron the show. Baseball.
We got baseball, baby. We got Ronnie and T-Kraz, final show today. Really getting us geared up for baseball in the Sweet 16 tomorrow. Please join us. We're going to be at the Hard Rock at the L Bar today, celebrating Ronnie and T-Kraz, their final show together. And I'm going to do it starting off with building a Freaky Five parlay. If you haven't been part of it, you haven't heard it, the first five callers to call in with their picks, they give me one pick. Doesn't matter what it is. Could be the worst pick in the world. I have to take it, and I want to win. I'm going to Vegas on Friday. I'm going to be out going to Vegas, and I'm trying to win a nice stack.
Give the guy some good bets today. Don't Please. Call in with the screwy bets asking him to bet on dumb stuff because he's trying to get to Vegas, and he's still got a roof to pay for.
And I'll post it on Twitter, at Jacobson on air, at Jacobson on air. I know some people were tailing me. We came very close on the crazy 10 last week. Let's go to Charlie, who's going to be the first selection of the Freaky Five, who was very good. He was on North Carolina and UConn last week, if I remember correctly.
Yes, that is correct. Good morning, Pat. Good morning, Aaron. And I was also on Peter Malnani at 40-1.
Wow. That was you? Was that you that emailed us?
I was
us?
Just going to say that. It is yes.
I mean, yeah. Dude, that was a, you won like, what, $2,000 off that almost?
25 for $1,000. I won wow. 15K last week.
Wow. 15K?
15K, yes. I can show it to you.
I mean, how about you just give it to me? You can give it to me. You don't need to show it to me. All right. I wish I was. I wish I had the balls to bet like that, man. Or
I wish I had the money to bet like that.
I've got. I just don't have. I can't pull the trigger on it. All right. Yeah. Like
Dude,
sometimes.
So I was.
Yeah.
So just to give you a little history of why I'm. It started out very young. I was 14 years old when I started gambling, and at age 15 at high school at St. Francis Prep in Queens, New York, I was the house bookie in high school. And so we Lamar Odom was playing for Christ the King with Speedy Claxton and Eric Barkley when I was in high school. It was a long time ago in the mid to late 90s. And I orchestrated all 50 boys, sophomores, take their shirts off at Christ the King after the first quarter buzzer beater. Like after the first quarter the buzzer went off,
settle down,
so all
P.
the
Diddy.
Nuns and the priests. What's that?
I said, settle down, P. Diddy.
Oh, that's too funny. So we all took our shirts off. 49 of the 50 kids got suspended. I get called in. I'm the 50th kid to get called into the dean's office. Ted John, his name was, and he goes, Charlie, who's the ringleader of this taking your shirts off in front of priests and nuns and embarrassing our school? I said, it was me, sir. He goes, you know that 3,000 in the ledger, it's now zero. Get out of my office. I was the only one out of 50 kids to not get suspended. I've been gambling for 30 years heavily, thousands of dollars. To bet $5,000 is like betting 5 cents.
What
and
is
it's
this?
Not because I'm rich. It's just
I love that, but I don't know what the shirtless story had to do with your gambling addiction. Did you fix or try to fix any games when you were running that ring in high school?
Never. Never. Nothing but integrity here.
What did you just like write the bets down? Like, is that how you did your bookmaking?
Yes, we had a dollar composition book, and Bobby, my high school quote is CNC Corp, pay me or else. It was me and Bobby Cruz. We were the two bookies.
Bobby
he
Cruz.
Ran with me. He was my partner.
Bobby the bookie.
Yep, he was my partner, and the teachers and the dean all bet with us. That's the whole point of telling you that the shirts off was because it's ingrained in me. I've been doing this for 30 years.
I see every time I go to put like a $100 bet down, I get scared. So I just take one of the zeros off and it just ends up with a $10 bet. And I win or lose nothing. All right. What's my bet today? What's my pick, Charlie? What do we got?
Today, you've got the Orlando Magic -5.5. The Golden State Warriors are on back-to-back yep. nights. They won last night on the road. They will not win two games on two consecutive nights. The state of Florida, they lose by about 9-11.
Tough game for them last night. I like that. I was looking at that earlier on the money line, but hey, it's part of the Freaky Five on the point spread. Thank you, Charlie. Appreciate it. And be careful out there.
And then I want you to take note this down. It's going to land on it directly. 94 wins for your Tampa Bay Rays.
I like you, Charlie. That's it. That's all I have to say is I like you.
Are you asking him out?
I don't know. I got a girlfriend, but I don't know, man. Will you let me will you let me watch my March games and not ask me for hanky-panky?
Absolutely, brother. You could text me, and I'll text you my picks. That's entirely up to you. You have my
number. All right. I'm going to save your number. I might do that, actually. I might do that. I love you, Charlie. Thank you. All right.
Thanks, Charlie.
If all you want to help out. Boys. Thank you, buddy. If you want to help out with the Freaky Five, 888-546-4620. We were talking about the NFL rule changes a little bit earlier on. Some big ones, especially the new kickoff rule. Bo. Is Bo still hanging around?
No. Yeah, Bo. I'm sorry. We lost Bo.
Sorry, Bo. All right. My bad, Bo. I really needed to selfishly get my Freaky Five. And Charlie was hanging in
there. Charlie's fantastic. What are we supposed to do?
That was amazing.
What are we supposed to do? Cut him off?
I think he's undercover. I think it's Ipe.
Charlie is Ipe. I think he's taking bets from Ipe. That's what he's doing. I would take bets from Ipe. Ipe's the worst gambler in the world.
You know, I was going to say, you can tell that Charlie is not Ipe. Charlie wins.
Yeah.
Charlie wins his bets.
Like, I would love if I had Ipe's around me, I would be a bookie because I know I'd be winning money. I would be like, Ipe, you have unlimited, whatever you want to spend, just you got to pay up front. Because you have no money, you're using Shohei's money.
You'd have Jacobson Pay Me or Else LLC. Is that what it was, Charlie, yeah, right?
That's exactly what Charlie did in his yearbook. Way to go, Charlie. And Bobby the bookie.
You know a phrase I never use very often in my life? Or else. Or else.
Yeah, it's a tough guy phrase.
Yeah, I'm not an or else guy.
I've never said or else.
It might be like, or else, I'm going to walk away and be very angry with you.
I've never given an ultimatum in my life. It's never happened. I don't have that in me. I can't stand by an ultimatum. I would just break it. 888-546-4620. Want to round out my Freaky Five. We're starting with the Magic 5.5-point favorites, but we've got tomorrow the Rays starting their season off against the Toronto Blue Jays. Zach Eflin on the bump. He's going to have to be big for them because you look at this rotation and you look at his injury history. You look at what he did last year. So productive. We're putting a lot on this guy. Last year, we didn't put it on him that he's going to come in and be the ace. Big offseason signing, a guy we wanted to come help out. He certainly did that. But the pressure this year is on. We don't know what Aaron Civale is going to become, and he's dealt with injuries himself. Hasn't pitched over 125 innings in his career, not once.
Even if we've got a lot of confidence in everybody behind Zach Eflin, just from being asked to go from, hey, you're our number three or four guy, basically number three guy, to you're now the ace. That alone, forget about what was happening behind him, that alone is a lot of pressure.
So Eflin's going to really have to show and extend himself like he did last year. Aaron Civale as well. And Zach Littell, there were no expectations last year. Now we have expectations for Zach Littell. Is he going to be able to reach those expectations? Tyler Alexander, a complete unknown. Ryan Pepiot, rounding it out, involved in that Glasnow trade. The name will be tied to Tyler Glasnow forever. So there's pressure there.
So Littell is a starter now, and we know that going into the season. But when you say there are expectations, what are they? For you, what are the expectations for Zach Littell? Because I'm optimistic about Zach, and I can't wait to see what we're going to get from him. And the best of what we saw from him last year was really, really good. But I don't know what my expectations are for him going into the year.
Innings eater. That's what he did last year. He came in when they battled injuries, and he ate innings up. Some successful, some not.
You said the expectations are different. So if that's what he did last year, like what is real? Like
the expectation is that you have success while you're eating innings. You're not just giving up runs. You're keeping the team in ball games. If he's able to do that and to go and eat those innings and not have short outings, then that's successful to me because Zach Littell is not going to be looked at as a top of the rotation, not even a number two guy. He's a middle to back end rotation. If the Rays are healthy, he's back end rotation, maybe not even in the rotation if the Rays are at full strength. So,
full strength. I mean, this rotation is stupid.
Yeah, just eat those innings up. And the unknown with Tyler Alexander and how they're going to use Jacob Wagispack, how they're going to use Davinsky. I still think they're going to have a role for Wagispack as starting role for him, whether it be an opener or whether it be a bulk role. And if you're in that bulk role, yeah, you're not starting the game. But if you're pitching bulk innings, you're essentially just as impactful as a starter.
Just as important, for sure.
Yes.
Without question. And they're going to need those kind of innings from a lot of guys. And the good news is, they seem to always find a way to get guys ready for that role when it's not something guys are brought up doing. It's going to happen more and more now because the Rays have changed the game of baseball. But for a long time, this is something that was very unique to guys coming into the league.
Stay healthy. That's it. That's the name of the game. Stay healthy. And I trust that the Eric Neander and company and Kevin Cash will know what guys to bring in and how to utilize those guys. That's the name of the game. When we're talking about retirement planning, the name of the game, Trajan Wealth, TrajanWealth.com, TrajanWealth.com. Retirement planning, wealth management, so important and stressful. It can be if you're trying to do it on your own. That's why the help is, and getting the right help is the best way to take that stress off your plate. Trajan Wealth, they are here to help you reach your investment goals, and they tailor the goals to your specific needs. And they do it by working closely with you. All they want at Trajan Wealth is your path to retirement to be an easy and a comfortable one. So will you have enough money when you retire? How long is that money going to last? Trajan Wealth, they're going to help you answer those questions. And it starts with a phone call today. Consultations are complimentary, so no need to wait. 813-550-1000. That's 813-550-1000. TrajanWealth.com. A family-owned and veteran-led business by Jeff Jr. And Jeff Jr. has been doing it for over 2 decades in the financial services profession. They're going to help you at Trajan Wealth develop a plan that gives you peace of mind. So like I said, no need to wait. 813-550-1000. 1000 TrajanWealth.com. Advisory services offered through Trajan Wealth LLC, an SEC registered investment advisor. Paid advertisement. On the other side, it's time to set the lines. Get our degenerate on. Over under is next.
WDAE traffic update.
A wreck on eastbound 674 near I-75 off to the right-hand side. Also one on Anderson and Limbaugh. And police activity blocking a number of lanes on Alamo Drive and 50th Street. Expect delays through that intersection. Westbound I-4, it's slow from Plant City over towards McIntosh Road. Southbound 275 between Fletcher Avenue and Hillsboro. And the southbound Suncoast Parkway a bit slow just south of State Road 54. With traffic, I'm Randy Myers.
This report is sponsored by Rasmussen University.
I had so many dreams, but life quickly got in the way. Then Rasmussen University saw my true potential and gave me the support and confidence I needed to become who I am today.
Rasmussen University. Learn more at rasmussen.edu/Florida.
I'm John Morgan. When people stop me to ask, what's my case worth? Here's what I tell them. All law firms are not the same at all. You see, the most important part of anyone's injury case is the firm you hire. The insurance company knows exactly which firms fight for full value and which firms will settle your case for pennies on the dollar. Our firm has recovered billions and billions and billions. $3 billion last year alone. There's only one Morgan & Morgan. Injured? Visit forthepeople.com for an office near you.
Since 1985, Bates Electric has served as Tampa's premier electrical contractor. As a veteran-owned and operated company, we bring a commitment to excellence in both commercial and residential projects. Our 24/7 gold service is Tampa's most recommended, and our dedicated electricians prioritize quality workmanship and unparalleled client communication, ensuring your project is on time and completed to perfection. See why clients rave about Bates Electric.
Power on, power on, power on Bates Electric. Power on.
Join us for our 2024 iHeartRadio Music Awards live from the Dolby Theater in Hollywood.
Monday, April 1st. Watch on Fox starting at 8 p.m. and listen on the free iHeartRadio app.
Otensla Apprentalast is a proud partner of the iHeartRadio Music Awards, a celebration of artists and the fans who got them there. The fans who make the music truly come alive through their energy and positive vibes. To the fans that make live music possible, we salute you.
Hi, this is Kevin Harlan. I know being a champion means you're a leader in your field and you always rise above your competition. That's why when summer temperatures get extreme, our home has a Champion air conditioning system that keeps my family comfortable and cool. Get peak performance in your home by finding a local Champion dealer at championhomecomfort.com. Ask about our special financing options with rates as low as 0% and our factory-backed extended parts and labor warranty. Always leading, never compromising, championhomecomfort.com.
A fraction of a raindrop, 3 grains of salt, add up to 100 times more potent than morphine. The tiniest amount of illegal fentanyl is all it takes to cause an overdose. Fentanyl can be mixed into heroin, cocaine, pressed pills, meth, and other drugs. It could be in your drugs, and you wouldn't be able to see it, taste it, or smell it. Learn more at cdc.gov/stopoverdose.
This report is sponsored by eBay Motors. eBay Motors is here for the ride with the parts you need for the prices you want. And with eBay Guaranteed Fit, it's guaranteed to fit your ride the first time, every time, or your money back. Keep your ride or die alive at ebaymotors.com. Eligible items only. Exclusions apply.
Mostly cloudy today. Slight chance of showers more likely in the afternoon. Our high 83. Overnight, a better chance of showers. 70% chance. Our low will drop back to 71. Tomorrow, more of the same. Mostly cloudy in the morning. Slight chance of showers and thunderstorms. About a 70% chance, actually, in the morning. And then sunny in the afternoon. Our high right around 76.
Live and local. Talking about your teams as only we can. This is WDAE. On your radio and streaming live on the iHeartRadio app. Download it now.
Game over.
Under.
Gee, I told you it was over.
Are you ready?
Time for a little over-under presented by HowardTeamHomeLoans.com with our guy, John Howard, the man, the myth, the legend.
That's right.
All right, what do we got, Casey Warner?
All right, let's go. First things first, we keep an opening day and March Madness NCAA tournament focus. Let's get it started with Blue Jays and Rays tomorrow. Over,
ooh,
under.
Ooh, let's do a tease with that. Blue Jays and Rays coming up, but yeah, real fast. I don't want to make Adam hang on. I meant to go to...
All right, let's go.
Adam's got a freaky five pick for me. If you're just joining us, I got one leg. Magic minus 5.5. My apologies. Casey, Adam, what is your... Good morning, and what is your pick for the freaky five?
Good morning. I got UNLV plus the 5.5.
UNLV...
Or the over.
Plus
141.
Plus 5.5?
Yeah, I think that's what it is, right?
What are they, in the NIT? What are we talking about here?
Yeah. All right.
Sorry, I haven't. Once USF got bounced, I'm out on the NIT.
Tonight.
All right, plus 5.5 UNLV.
Right,
there
thanks,
you go.
Adam.
I'm betting NIT basketball.
Let's go.
I got a real basketball fan right there.
Thank
that's
you,
a true
Adam.
Basketball fan. The running Rebels, baby. Let's go.
What if I win a massive load because I did the NIT bet? I love it.
Two basketball bets, and neither of them are March Madness. Neither of them are the tournament. Isn't that crazy?
That's wild. That's freaky five. That's how you do it. All right, what do we have?
That. All right, over under 7.5 total runs. Blue Jays at Rays tomorrow.
Over, and I won't say why because I know what the next one is.
Okay, Aaron?
I'm going to go over. I think things are going to start slow, and then they get some production going. New turf. They're psyched. I'm going to go over.
All right, so with that being said, over under 3.5 opening day runs for the Rays.
Well, over. I said over for the first one because I didn't want to talk about the second one, and I'm going to say over for the second one because I'm excited for opening day. I think the Rays are excited for opening day. I don't think the Blue Jays are. That's, of course, not true, but I don't care. I'm going to say the Rays put up a bunch of runs tomorrow, and it's a blast at Tropicana Field for opening day.
Over. Over, over.
Okay, over, over. Well, with that being said, you think the Rays are going to score a lot. You think there's going to be a lot of runs scored. The spread is minus 1.5 for the Rays versus the Blue Jays. So do you see it going over, under 1.5?
So basically, the Rays have to win by two or more runs, is what you're telling me. Pat?
Over. Over. I just said that I think the Rays are going to score a bunch of runs.
It's going to be a blowout.
I'm feeling optimistic. It may not be a blowout, but the Rays are going to win by at least four runs.
What do you think, Aaron?
Yeah. Right now, I'm looking. Have the Rays, I know, or not the Rays, have the Blue Jays, because yesterday you and I checked, they hadn't named their starter yet.
Really? I knew they hadn't named their starter for.
I would think it'd
be
Barrios.
Who's their opener?
Barrios, right?
I don't know.
It is Barrios.
Okay,
yeah.
So I didn't know how everything went out with their last spring start. All right, so Barrios is getting the nod as their opening day starter. That makes sense. I'm going to go Rays play a lot of one-run games. Rays are going to win by one. Close game. It's going to be 5-4 Rays final. So under.
All righty. And we have some player over-unders on the Hard Rock Bet app. There's only one Rays player that came in under any of those. They got one for home runs, RBIs, hits, stolen bases, all those stats. And the only one that a Rays player was under was home runs, so I chose that one over-under.
Really?
Yep, that's
what
it.
What if you go on the team? Can you go on the team and find futures?
I don't think so. I think it's just team wins, and then it has them all listed, and then the player over-unders are just select players from what I saw. So, yeah, I mean, you can check it out, but over-under 23.5 home runs for Randy Arozarena.
Give me over. I think he's going to be closer to 30. I don't know if this is his 30 home run year, but I see a lot of stolen bases. I see a lot of gappers. I see a lot of excitement. Fortunately, I see a lot of strikeouts, but I'm going to go over on the home runs, over 23.5 for me.
I'm going to go over as well. I think he is right there around 30, like Aaron was saying. May not be over, but it's going to be right around there.
Well, he got jacked this offseason, so I would hope he's going to hit the over. Let's see it. All right, we're moving on to those March Madness NCAA tournament over-unders.
Let's go.
Here we go. First one, over-under, minus 1.5, Iowa State spread versus Illinois.
Great game. Really great game. We talked about this earlier. With all the a lot of the favorites winning, we're going to see great games in the Sweet 16. This is the first one that I think is going to be great. Illinois is going to, I've got them winning. So I'm going to go with whatever that is.
Now,
under.
Is that under?
It would be
under,
because Iowa State's favorite.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. All right. Well, then that's what I was going to say. If it, is it? I didn't know if you meant over under, like on the game or for the favorite.
Yeah, -1.5. That's the spread. So just over under the spread.
Go under. It's basically pick 'em.
Yeah, I'll take the under as well.
All righty, can't wait for that one. Another good one is the only quote-unquote maybe Cinderella left, 11-seed NC State. Over-under, -6.5, Marquette spread versus NC State.
Over. This is when NC State, who's been playing so well, they got a guy who is that big kid, that big lefty. I already forgot his name. Doesn't look like he'd be able to put the ball in the hoop like he does at will. So dominant in the paint. But with that said, I think their run comes to an end. I think Marquette separates themselves in the second half. I'm going to go over.
Yeah, I think it's over as well. I think they separate themselves early, actually, and make it look pretty easy.
All right, two seeds. All on board for those two seeds today.
DJ Burns. That's what I'm thinking of.
DJ Burns. Big man.
He's become a March Madness hero.
That's right.
Been in college for 6 years.
Couple more here. Over under 134.5 total points, Duke versus Houston.
That's a lot.
It's actually the lowest one of the weekend.
Yeah.
Is it really?
Lowest one. Lowest over under.
Yeah, it's low. I'm going to go under. Sorry. I'm going to go over. I think this game's going to be like Houston's going to win this game 76-71 or 70.
I'm going to take the under, actually. I think I kind of feel the same way about Houston that I do about Marquette. I think that they ride this one out not easily necessarily, but I think they win by 10 or 15 points and it's not as close as people think.
I hope so. Love to see Duke lose. All right, one more. Sticking with Duke and ACC. Over under 2.5 ACC teams in the Elite Eight. I put Sweet 16. I'm in Elite Eight. Over two
or
over
winning
under,
the Sweet 16.
Yeah, 2.5 ACC teams winning in the Sweet 16. There we go. Clemson, UNC, Duke, and NC State are all in the Sweet 16.
Ready for this? I'm going under, and it's good. I love that over under. And not only am I going to go under, I'm going to go zero.
Whoa!
I'm going to go none of them advance. I'm going to say Clemson, UNC, Duke, and NC State all lose in the Sweet 16.
I think there's a really good chance that you're right. I think I have UNC getting past Alabama, so let's hope that doesn't happen. I'm going to say they get at least UNC because I want to win this damn WFAN pool. Yeah, I'm going to take the under as well, though. I don't have a lot of confidence in anybody outside of UNC.
North Carolina would be the only favorite out of the ACC teams heading into this. So, I've got them all losing.
All right. Gotcha. That's all we have for over-under today from the penalty box. Back to y'all.
There's over-under presented by HowardTeamHomeLoans.com. Do want to remind people you could watch us on YouTube, Facebook, and Twitch. Just search WDAE because in a couple minutes, you're going to want to be tuned in and watching. If you can, Doug Wechter is going to be in studio, on camera, on air as we are one day away from opening day baseball for the Tampa Bay Rays. That's all coming up in a big 8 o'clock hour. Don't go anywhere.
The Player of the Night, presented by Rivard Buick GMC.
It took double overtime in Milwaukee, but the Lakers beat the Bucks 128-124, leaving the way for LA. It was Anthony Davis down low, 34 points, 23 rebounds, 4 blocks to boot, making him your Rivard Buick GMC Player of the Night. Lakers big man Anthony Davis. Rivard Buick GMC, no games, no gimmicks, no hidden fees. Check out their inventory at RivardBuickGMC.com. We are professional grade. I am Zach Blobner, and of course, this is 95.3 WDAE and AM 620.
Rivard Buick GMC, the number 3. Wait a minute. I got that wrong there. Rivard Buick GMC, the number 2 GMC dealer in the country. That's right. Rivard Buick GMC is now the number 2 GMC dealer in the entire country. How'd they get there? Well, massive inventory, which means you've got options. Insane discounts you just won't see these days. Go to RivardBuickGMC.com and see for yourself. And last but not least, a staff to help you get through the car buying process start to finish. Visit RivardBuickGMC.com today. GMC. We are professional grade.
It's not just hump day, it's Wacky Wednesday. Your day to get a flavorful deal at Hungry Howie's. Get a large cheese or pepperoni pizza, oven-baked spaghetti and sub, or any regular salad for just $7.99. All day, every Wednesday, and only at Hungry Howie's.
Wacky Wednesday.
Hey guys, T-Kraz here for C4MH.com. Well, it's the holiday season, and with all that comes the New Year's resolutions, guys, to hit the gym. But remember, if you're over 40, you can't build muscle with low T. Testosterone is the primary hormone needed needed for building muscle. And if you have low T, you'll be working twice as hard at the gym and getting nowhere. So know before you go. Get your testosterone tested at C4MH.com. Just $45 gets you lab results and a medical exam. And C4MH.com only treats with pharmaceutical testosterone, never that cheap cut-rate compounded T that all those pop-up T clinics use. C4MH.com never makes you pay for treatments in advance. No financial contracts to sign. No financing needed. As C4MH.com is a medical clinic, not a marketing company. Just $85 for treatment twice a month and $90 for labs. No surprises and no upsells or add-ons. C4MH.com, the leader in low-T care. 18 locations between Tarping Springs and Naples. Hit them up at C4MH.com.
The best live thoroughbred racing around. It is at Tampa Bay Downs. Easy to get to, right in our backyard. And on Wednesdays, it is free. And then Fridays, Saturdays, and Sundays, it's only $3. Gates open at 11 a.m. Post time for the first race, 12:15. You can get your programs there at the program stands for $2.25. It's easy. You get informed by reading those programs. A race day program, it's going to show you all the information you need. So for the bettors out there, the inexperienced bettors, that's going to help you out. Plus, they've got tip sheets for the inexperienced bettors, so you can make some good bets and potentially win some big money. Always great things happening at Tampa Bay Downs. April 7th from 12 to 3, you're going to have the entire family having some great times out there on the track. Everyone's going to get to meet the track mascot, Mouse the Miniature Horse, and also the kids can enjoy the pony rides, bounce houses, a variety of games, all these great activities. April 7th, 12 to 3, only at Tampa Bay Downs. Check them out online, TampaBayDowns.com. That's TampaBayDowns.com.
Trade-a-thon is always one of Brandon Ford's most popular sales events. So Trade-a-thon 2024 is going to be unbelievable.
Going to be unbelievable.
You want to get rid of all those toys you don't want anymore? Cars, trucks, boats, campers, motorcycles. We don't care if you have to tow it in or push it that last mile, but you don't need to trade anything to get our Trade-a-thon deals.
You don't need to trade anything to get our Trade-a-thon deals.
Like gorgeous new 2024 F-150 Crew Cab STXs with the black appearance package, huge 12-inch touchscreen, and premium 20-inch wheels and a custom spray and bed liner for just $46,699.
$46,699.
We have 100 of these trucks, or get 1.9% for 72 months on new 2023 F-150s.
Please note, during the sale, every customer qualifies for the branded Ford price.
And no other Ford dealer in this part of the country can beat that price. No hidden fees during Trade-a-thon 2024 at Brandon Ford, the largest volume Ford truck dealer in America. Highway 60 and 301 in Tampa, and at BrandonFord.com.
Ronnie Lane here, joined by the MVP of the Holland Group Retirement Wealth Advisors, co-founder and president, Elizabeth Holland.
The one thing I love most about football is the team effort it takes to win a game. All phases of the team have to work together and be at their very best to get the job done.
That's what your team at the Holland Group does every day, right? Your team of advisors, led by Steve and you, puts together comprehensive retirement plans designed to preserve and grow assets while applying tax-advantaged strategies to make sure your clients keep every single cent they are legally entitled to. That's what I call a win.
That's exactly right. And unlike most other financial firms, we do it all under one roof. This is where the Holland Group becomes your X factor, and we can design a customized, inflation-adjusted, and tax-advantaged retirement plan.
Nobody wins by sitting on the bench, so call the Hollands at 727-469-7939 or visit askthehollands.com. Let's make the rest of your life the best of your life.
When you can't crank up the speakers in the office, plug in those earbuds and download the free iHeartRadio app. You can take WDAE and your home for sports, music, talk, and podcasts all in one app. Free never sounded so good. Presented by the law offices of Anajar and Levine, accident attorneys. Call 1-800-747-FREE.
That's 1-800-747-3733.
Broadcasting from the Rude Air Conditioning Studios. This is Tampa Bay's home for the best sports conversation in the Bay. We are 620 WTAE St. Petersburg, 95.3 FM W237 CW Pinellas Park, 95.7 HD3 WBTP Clearwater, 96.7 FM W224 BE Brandon. Streaming live on the free iHeartRadio app. Listen for all your music, sports, talk, and podcasts. Free never sounded so good.
It's time, man!
Fun in dysfunctional.
Yeah! Yeah!
Each and every weekday morning, the Pat and Aaron Show.
Is this a little too early for being that loud?
Good morning, Tampa Bay.
And here we go.
Now your hosts, Pat Donovan and Aaron Jacobson.
Hour number three of the Pat and Aaron Show on 95.3 WDAE and AM 620, and it is a Wechter Wednesday. Our good friend Doug Wechter is with us, as he is every Wednesday once baseball returns. Hell, even before baseball returns, we couldn't wait to get Doug back, so we brought him back. Doug Wechter 10 on social media, good place to find him if you might be looking for a new home and a good realtor. Yeah. Mr. Wechter, how are you, my friend? I missed you last week.
Yeah, doing good, man. So, yeah, welcome back from vacation. You look relaxed. You don't look that much more tan, though.
I'm not.
You're on the beach.
We were near the beach.
There's no tanning for you.
Remember this past weekend, by the way, we got lucky on Saturday. Friday. We got lucky on Friday because it didn't...
the weather?
It didn't rain like it was supposed to.
Yeah.
But it wasn't sunny.
No.
Thursday a little bit, but...
Did you get any beach time in?
I got some pool time in.
Yeah. That a boy.
I'm a pool guy.
In lounge?
Outdoor pool.
Outdoor pool.
Yeah. You saw the picture.
Oh, I keep thinking it's photoshopped.
Why?
I don't know.
He looks like Arnold Schwarzenegger.
He looks great in the picture.
It's an interesting, like, the body and the head don't really, like, it doesn't seem like his head. You got a pretty big head.
I have an enormous head.
I like the Jose Siri necklace. We might need to get that. Get you an extra large, though.
Yeah. Like a lot of things.
March 31st, the first 12,000 at the Trop are getting one of those.
Yep. That's this Sunday.
It is this Sunday.
What's up, big guy?
How are you? Oh, yeah, big guy. I was looking at Pat when I told you, what's up, big guy, and you walked in between. Yeah. Like, you took that compliment and just walked away with it. Now you're telling everyone I said big guy to you.
Somebody makes physical contact with my shoulder and follows up with big guy.
I did not touch you.
It's for me.
I did not touch you.
On the text line, do you see this, Doug? I'm getting hate. Love your show. Never will stop listening. Well, that's very nice. And supporting you guys. Appreciate that. But what's with the increase in betting stuff and promoting it? Not a fan of that. Love you guys.
I love the compliment first and then just, you know, tears you down. It's like, bless his heart. He's awful.
I'm a degenerate.
Yeah, you always have.
I always have been. Yeah, it's legal now, so I can talk about it legally. I used to say Monopoly money. Listen,
and now we can actually look at the app, make bets. Like, it's just, it's different. It's there. It's fun.
Everyone's doing it. Shohei's doing it. Ipe's doing it. Shohei might be doing it. Ipe's doing it.
Yeah, Doug Aaron likes to call it a healthy addiction.
I don't know if that's a good way to describe it.
I should probably stop doing that.
Yeah, I don't think that's a good way to describe
probably should.
It.
But for Ipe, it wasn't. For Shohei, we don't know what's going on. Let's start with that, Doug. Of course, we got opening day tomorrow we want to get into. But as far as like going into regular season baseball, there could not be a worse story for Rob Manfred and Major League Baseball for this to break going into the season.
Yeah. Look, he's the face of Major League Baseball right now. And it's worldwide. It's not, you know, American and the USA. And this is our big, you know, this is worldwide news. And, you know, as of right now, it's there's a lot to it. Right. You're trying to dive into it, trying to figure out everything, how much you believe, how much you don't believe, whatever it says. But it's not a good situation for baseball. They're trying to handle it kind of like the crisis management type thing. Like, how do we handle this with our biggest star? And then you just kind of got to let the legal system play out. That being said, it's not good. It's not what you want going into the biggest day of the year, essentially, for baseball, which I consider a national holiday.
And by the way, it broke during the first opening day. It broke basically while everyone was in Korea for that series, which you know baseball hated, and I thought ESPN probably could have waited, but that's another story. But like, the whole, you're right, the whole thing is so massive, and it's hard. I want so badly to believe Shohei Ohtani,
right?
But Aaron and I have been discussing this the last couple days. I'm confused. I can't figure out, and there's been no discussion about how or why his translator had access to his bank account.
Well, you know, I've thought about this a lot, too. You know, look, it's really hard to figure out. And I'm choosing to believe that Shohei is a man of his word. He says he is innocent. And I believe it, man. I want to believe it. And so I'm going to believe that. So that's what I'm sticking with. There's a couple things you look at and you're like, holy cow, how did he get access to that amount of funds?
and essentially go the whole thing,
it's
right? How did it really happen? But either way, I'm choosing to believe Shohei because honestly, I just don't want to see him be involved in something like this. He's not that guy. He never seemed like that guy. And really that it's something that needs to go away from Major League Baseball as quickly as possible and be resolved.
Would you feel the same way about rumors if they came out about me? You'd be like, I don't want to believe them.
I would say they're all true. And it doesn't matter what the rumor is. you big guy, that just didn't happen.
Which it did.
That did not happen.
Would you sweep it under the rug if you were Major League Baseball and you could?
I don't think they're sweeping it. I don't think you can.
Yeah.
I mean, it's too big of a story.
Would you be shady enough to do it?
It's just too big of a story, but I think what's going to have to happen is... Well, what's going to happen is opening day is going to start up, and this story will take a back seat because now opening day is something for all the fans to focus on. And yeah. I'll tell you what, man, I was at the shop yesterday. We were doing a radio broadcast. I am so excited about this season, and I get this way every year. Going into opening day, it's one of my favorite days. It's like Christmas Day for me. And just
Merry
going
Christmas.
Out there, yeah, thank you. Yeah. Well, it's Christmas Eve then.
Yeah, right? Merry Christmas Eve. Yeah. The Eve's great.
Yeah, so, you know, going out there, everybody feels like this could be their year, right? You have hope no matter where your team is, even if you think we got some holes here or there or whatever.
A's have no hope.
Yeah, the A's have
no hope. The A's have no hope.
But there's excitement for everybody. And just opening day being around.
Is there excitement for A's fans?
For everybody in Tampa Bay.
Yes. That I agree with.
I love it, man. I love it. I'm going to be there early tomorrow. I love the excitement. I love the noise in the stadium. I love the smells. I love the sounds. I love everything about it. And opening day just marks a new year. And it's tomorrow. That's the excitement I have right now.
One of the guys that I have been most excited about, and, you know, part of it is certainly like that new toy feel, right? But one of the guys I've been most excited about, optimistic about when it comes to this upcoming season is Ryan Pepiot. Looked really good again yesterday. His last two starts has been really, really good. You've been talking about it's those last couple starts, right, where you really want to pick things up. Talk about what you've seen. You obviously, like you said on the call yesterday, what you've seen with his progression over the course of the spring.
Yeah, so comfort-wise, he looks so much better than he did, I would say, four or five starts ago, which is typical, right? This guy's coming over to a new team. He's got a lot of adjustments to make, a lot of new faces to meet, and just get comfortable in a new environment. He has done that 100%. Now you look at what he's doing on the field. This guy is going to be outstanding. Okay, he's going to be really good. He sits 94, 96 on average. Power arm, carries it all the way through his outing. He doesn't tear off in the last few innings. What I saw from him yesterday, though, was very impressive to me because he wasn't leaning on the fastball so much. He had like 7 or 8 punch outs, and I think it was 5 or 6 innings. Whatever it was, there was a lot of swing and miss, and that was because he was able to go out there and hitters counts and throw secondary pitches for strikes.
It was 8-6 for the record.
8-6 for the record, just so everybody knows. and so he went out there yesterday, and this was the most impressive thing to me, is that in 3-1 counts, I'd say 2-1 counts, 3-1 counts, whatever it was, 2-0 counts. He's dropping changeups and sliders in there easily for strikes on the corner. All right, this is a guy who had 17 games in the big leagues, 10 of them were starts. Now, they've been good, right? His overall record in the major leagues is like 5-1 in sub 3 ERA. So he's been good. He just hasn't had a lot of time in. But to go out there and show that you're comfortable enough to throw secondary pitches that are swing and miss secondary pitches and throw them for strikes in any count, that's where he's going to separate himself because now he's a pitcher with stuff. He's not one or the other. A lot of times you get these young guys who are stuff guys, and it takes about, you know, half a season. It just takes a half season or longer for these guys to mature, for these guys to understand, you know, Snyder and what he's trying to teach them, all that stuff. Well, it looks like Pepiot has already kind of grasped that based off of the last couple outings I've seen. And if that's what we're going to see throughout the season, I mean, this dude is going to be really, really good for the Rays.
I'm a strikeout to walk ratio guy. And when you look at his strikeout walk ratio, it makes me really optimistic about the season he's about to have. Tyler Alexander, there's a guy that's going to be, he could help us. He could be in the rotation for a while. He might be in the rotation for a little bit. Were you surprised with him getting named into the starting rotation? We had heard about Waggis Pack. You know I'm a Wag Packer.
Yes.
And we've got Davinsky who's going to be in the bullpen. How do you think it's going to shape up here early on in the season with the starters?
I'm optimistic. I'm hopefully optimistic, I guess I could say. I'll go through the rotation for you. I think if Eflin takes the ball every 5 games, he'll be the number one guy we need. He's that good. Last year, he had 16 wins, career high across the board, right? This dude had over 180 punch outs, 177 in the third innings pitch, somewhere around there. And those are all career highs. So if he can just repeat what he did last year, he'll be our number one and the anchor that this team needs, right? So I think he's going to be good as long as he's healthy. I think Savali at the two spot, I think that, you know, he has the most room for growth. And I'm not saying that he had a bad year last year. What I'm saying is his potential is there to be really good and to be a top of the rotation type of arm somewhere in the, you know, somewhere in the first three spots of a rotation mix. Right?
We need him to be this
year. He can be
sure.
That guy. He can be that guy. I think he's one of the biggest keys to the rotation this year because, you know, they traded for him last year with certain expectations and they feel like he can still come through on those expectations. So he should be pretty good. Littell's going to be really good. Like him, he's an innings eater. Alexander, I think he's penciled in for the fourth.
And
so
Pepio
either an
fifth.
Opener or somehow, I think he's going to be good for us. And then you just heard me on Pepio. So
is a wag packer a thing or did you create
it's
that
a
last
thing for
week?
Jacobson.
I created that last
You created
week.
That
yeah,
last
yeah,
week.
I'm a wag packer.
All right. Well, yeah. Listen, we got one more thing we need to call Jeff Atenella about. All right.
Aaron, that's a good shirt.
Start the wag pack.
Yeah.
The Jacobson wag pack.
I like that. That's why I need him to really get going this year. I need him to be good.
Yeah.
You need a Waggis Peck jersey. I want to see you walking around
yep.
with those.
Turf. I want to get into turf on the other side.
Yeah,
can we
do.
Get into the turf?
We'll get into the new turf. We'll also get into expectations. Aaron and I made our predictions on the Rays and how many victories they'll have this season. We'll see if we can tie down Doug Wechter into a prediction on the other side. That's coming up on the Pat and Aaron Show on 95.3 WDAE and AM 620.
From the Whatever It Takes Moss Nissan Traffic Center.
WDAE. Traffic update.
Southbound US 19 slow approaching Gulf to Bay. Also a crash on northbound 49th Street just north of Park Boulevard, blocking a couple lanes. Seeing delays in Tampa, southbound 275 Fletcher Avenue towards Hillsboro, and southbound 75 now slow south of Bruceby Downs, the past Fowler Avenue. Crash off to the right hand side, eastbound 674 near I-75. With traffic, I'm Randy Myers.
This report is sponsored by Rasmussen University.
I had so many dreams, but life quickly got in the way. Then Rasmussen University saw my true potential and gave me the support and confidence I needed to become who I am today. Rasmussen University. Learn more at rasmussen.edu/Florida.
Hey, it's Brett from Bull Oak. Are you struggling from erectile dysfunction? We've got a groundbreaking solution that's transformed the lives of thousands of men. Our WAVE technology is backed by 50 clinical studies, including research from prestigious Cambridge University. It revitalizes blood flow by repairing blood vessels, all without the need for pills or the worry of side effects. If you're ready to end your erectile dysfunction struggles, call us now. Not only will you get a free assessment and blood flow ultrasound, we're also throwing in your first treatment free on us. That's right. Give us a call and schedule an appointment, and we'll get you your first treatment free. This is a $600 value, and it's yours free if you call in the next 2 minutes. Call 813-219-1919. That's 813-219-1919. Guys, it's time to reclaim your love life and put an end to your erectile dysfunction. Call 813-219-1919. Call Bull Oak now to qualify. 813-219-1919.
And we're live here outside the Perez family home just waiting for the... And there they go! Almost on time this morning. Mom is coming out the front door strong with a double-arm kid carry. Looks like Dad has the bags. Daughter is bringing up the rear. Oh, but the diaper bag wasn't closed. Diapers and toys are everywhere. Ooh, but Mom has just nailed the perfect car seat buckle for the toddler. And now the eldest daughter, who looks to be about 9 or 10, has secured herself in the booster seat. Dad zips the bag closed, and they're off. Ah, but looks like Mom doesn't realize her coffee cup is still on the roof of the car. And there it goes. Oh, that's a shame. That mug was a fam favorite.
Don't sweat the small stuff. Just nail the big stuff, like making sure your kids are buckled correctly in the right seat for their age and size. Learn more at nhtsa.gov/the right seat.
Visit nhtsa.gov/the right seat.
Brought to you by NHTSA and the Ad Council.
RiseCon 2024 is back and better than ever. Global entrepreneur and Tampa's very own Vic Tipness brings together the world's most elite event for entrepreneurs to Tampa to help people live their max life. On April 19th through the 21st, join Vic along with MLB All-Star Alex Rodriguez, NFL Hall of Famer Deion Sanders, political analyst Tucker Carlson, and many more. Get your tickets at theriseconference.com. Invest in yourself and watch your life transform. Get your tickets at theriseconference.com today. You do not want to miss this event.
Ball four, take your base.
The only thing worse than a pitcher running out of gas on the mound is your old phone running out of storage for your photos in the stands.
Goodbye, home run.
Switch to Verizon and get a great deal on a new iPhone 15 Pro with tons of storage for all the ballpark pics you want. Just trade in your iPhone, any model, in any condition, so you'll feel like you're winning. Even when your team's not. Trade in any iPhone in any condition for a great deal on iPhone 15 Pro with Unlimited Ultimate and get iPad and Apple Watch SE with eligible service plan. Only on Verizon.
Since 1985, Bates Electric has proudly served as Tampa's premier electrical contractor. As a veteran-owned and operated company, we bring a commitment to excellence in both commercial and residential projects. Our 24/7 gold service is Tampa's most recommended electric contractor. Our dedicated electricians prioritize quality workmanship and unparalleled client communication, ensuring your project is on time and completed to perfection. See why our clients rave about Bates Electric.
Power on, power on, power on, Bates Electric.
Tampa Golfers, Global Golf Outlet is now open with the largest selection of used clubs in Florida. You'll find thousands of used name brand clubs to choose from all at one location. TaylorMade, Callaway, Titleist, Ping, Cleveland, and more, all at incredible prices. And at Global Golf Outlet, you'll also find hundreds of closeout deals on bags, shoes, and apparel. It's Florida's largest and only golf outlet where you can try, buy, and trade all in one place. Global Golf Outlet, located on Gunn Highway in the Hampton Plaza.
This report is sponsored by Rasmussen University.
I had so many dreams, but life quickly got in the way. Then Rasmussen University saw my true potential and gave me the support and confidence I needed to become who I am today.
Rasmussen University. Learn more at rasmussen.edu/Florida.
Mostly cloudy today. Slight chance of showers, more likely in the afternoon. Our high 83. Overnight, a better chance of showers, 70% chance. Our low will drop back to 71. Tomorrow, more of the same. Mostly cloudy in the morning. Slight chance of showers and thunderstorms. About a 70% chance, actually, in the morning. And then sunny in the afternoon. Our high right around 76.
Have you downloaded the free iHeartRadio app yet? Just think, you could take WDAE and your home for sports, music, talk, and podcasts all on one app. Free never sounded so good. Presented by the law offices of Anajar and Levine, accident attorneys. Call 1-800-747-FREE.
That's 1-800-747-3733.
Pat Aaron Show, 95.3 WDAE and AM 620. It's a Wector Wednesday on the eve of opening day. And make sure you're tuned in all day tomorrow. From sunrise all the way through the first pitch and the game, it's all live right here on WDAE. We'll be live in our regular time slot from 6 to 9. Then Jay and Z will be bumped up from 9 to noon. And then T-Kraz and the debut of The Drive will be from noon to 3, leading us into Rays baseball coverage. It's all day, all live here on 95.3 WDAE and presented by the Central Florida Behavioral Health Network and the Department of Children and Families and your home of Rays baseball, 95.3 WDAE and AM 620.
What time are you getting there, Dave?
By the way, did you guys say you're going to be broadcasting from the Trop tomorrow?
Yeah, yes.
Oh,
6
nice.
To 9.
Nice.
What time
on
are you
site.
There? What time are you going to be there?
On site. I got to be in my makeup trailer at like 6 a.m. No.
How long is your makeup
I don't have a makeup trailer. You want to hear something funny?
Yeah.
So it took me a couple years to even put on makeup. I was just one of those guys. I was like, well, I don't understand why, you know, I don't care if my face has scars or whatever to it. It's not that big a deal to me. And I just never considered putting on makeup for camera. And so after like 2 or 3 years, people start telling me like, hey, look, you know, it's not really to cover up things. It's more about the glare because it's so bright in the studio. And so I was like, oh, okay, maybe I should start putting on a little bit of makeup. And so the first maybe month or two that I was doing it, I was kind of going in the room, in the bathroom, and like putting a little bit on my forehead so that nobody would see. I almost like not embarrassed, but I didn't want to broadcast that I was putting the stuff on. And so I didn't even buy it. It was my wife's makeup, right? This compact. And so
you know what it is.
Yeah. And so we're down in Fort Lauderdale and they have cubicles in the studio and then you walk into the actual studio to do the broadcasting. So it was like a month after I started putting this makeup on, I left my wife's compact on the desk and didn't know it. And I'm just doing some work for the pregame show and an intern comes by, a college intern. She's a female. And she's walking by and she's like, oh my God, we have the same makeup. And she said it as loud as possible for the entire office to hear. And I looked up, I was like, oh, I was like, yeah, it's okay. And after, at that point, I was like, whatever. It doesn't matter. Everybody wears it on air.
Everybody.
And now you know if you forget it, you can look to this young lady and say, can I borrow your concealer?
No, it's hilarious because now it's to the point where like people will be walking by at the Trop, you know, where we're at and left field. And, you know, we're just hanging over the rail saying hi to everybody and all our, and I'm like powdering my face. I'm putting makeup on my forehead so I don't look sweaty on air and people are just walking by. Yeah, it's great.
It's official. How did the turf look, by the way? I saw you take pictures. I loved it.
When you guys walk in there tomorrow, it's the first thing you're going to notice. It is such a fresh look to the field. Is I personally, and I've seen that field for I don't know how long, right?
Couple years.
Yeah, I mean, I was at the first game. I think my first year there was 03 when I got in the big leagues. It's the best I've ever seen that surface look. And it's really cool. So I didn't get a chance to feel it, but I got good reports from a ton of people about, first of all, the feel of it, how it plays, ground balls, all that stuff, the bounces that it takes.
Softer?
It's
softer,
yeah,
the turf?
Yeah,
I read that it was.
It just feels like natural grass.
Good, because it was so hard.
Plays. It feels in place,
in
my
opinion. Turf before was, it wasn't the best.
No, I mean, it was fine. Just the technology wasn't there. I think it just, you keep advancing in technology, and now everybody's going to see the color, but, you know, the stripes, they look so good.
It wasn't bad. I want to clarify. It wasn't bad last year. It was just, it was challenging. Like, anybody who had to play, who's been on there and has felt it.
And it gets matted down.
It's like concrete sometimes.
Yeah, you just remember it gets matted down with play and all that other stuff. So it's just a fresh look. Now, I will say one of the coolest things I learned was that the turf in the grass area and the turf in the warning track. Have you guys already heard this?
No.
That they have different filler in the turf. So in the turf on the regular grass, I believe it's like some type of brown soil or sand, so it feels like natural grass. And then when they get to the turf in the warning track, it's actually crushed up like, I think it's like almond nuts or coconut nuts.
Yeah, something. Coconut.
Yeah. And so the reason for that is when the outfielder is running on regular turf, you could be running and not know the difference when you're running on the green part and the warning track.
Oh, yeah.
So on a natural field, the reason for a warning track is so you don't have to look down and know how close you are to the fence, right? Now there's a warning sign. These guys will know it when they're running and feel a difference from the outfield turf grass to the warning track.
I love it. Aaron, we're going to be there early enough.
Yeah, you got to check it out. Go take ground balls.
We got to go run out there and just feel it.
No, you cannot. Stay away from the field.
Stay away.
Yeah.
We'll be on the field.
Every year, they stare at us. They're like,
I'm going to have them check your credentials twice. I can't believe you guys listen.
There's a guy at the door that checked him 18 times already.
That's my buddy.
And no offense.
I
no
showed
offense
him
guy
your
at the
pictures.
Door.
I was like, hey, really? I need you guys to give these guys a hard time.
I've literally been standing there looking at the guy going, I promise you I work for the radio partner, and like we're on the air in 5 minutes, if you don't mind. Like,
well, that's why we should get there before 5 minutes.
Well, you know, listen, do you think I get there five minutes before our broadcast? You know how early I am.
I try to go in without Pat because he gets so annoyed sometimes going in. I'm like, I can't be. It's bad energy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, like, people should try to be helpful. And that one gentleman is not necessarily helpful. That's all I'm saying.
He's a good man.
Doug, we said we would try to get a prediction from you before the break. What are you thinking?
Did either of you guys pick over 90?
Aaron picked 92.
Yeah, I like
picked
that.
88.
I like that.
I like over 90 for sure.
I hope so.
I don't believe that they're going to get to where they were last year. What was it, 99?
99,
yeah.
It'd be really hard to get to 99 because that was such a, I mean, they had such a great start to the year last year, and it really helped pad those numbers. But I can see them in the low 90s. You want me to put an actual number on it?
Yeah,
let's go with 93.
You just
I feel like I'm in the Price is Right. You know what? I mean, the Price is Right. And when that one guy picks $1, like he just wants to go either really low, or the one guy picks one over the other guy.
Yeah.
That's where I'm going to go.
It's because of the stupid rule that you can't
that
go
way,
over.
Anything,
it's the worst rule.
Anything over at 93 or over, I win. You know what I mean?
Yeah. No, that's what happened last year with Pat. He was, you were over 100 last year.
I think I was at 101 last year. I still think I was the closest. Me and Retcher both, we split the money from Knucklehead.
I don't know who that is.
Yeah,
Geo.
Oh, yeah.
I do think, so my prediction is 93 or more, and we're going to make the playoffs. That's my prediction.
But not win the division?
It'll be us or Baltimore.
You know who the favorite in the division is, according to the bookmakers?
Who?
The Yankees.
I totally disagree with that. I just don't see that at all right
now. The Rays are behind the Blue Jays.
You don't disagree with that? I don't see the Yankees.
No. Not how do you disagree. How are they second in anybody's mind?
Well, I think that the health of Gerrit Cole, the Yankees.
No. Baltimore's got to do it again. They got to show that these guys are going to continue on that trajectory.
But even if they don't, do you think the Yankees are the second place team? Because I don't.
I think they're going to be around. And then the Red Sox.
They'll be around. No, the Red Sox won't be around. The Red Sox they're in a tough spot right now.
What did you say? Plus 1750 or something for them
in the division.
Is it really?
Yeah. The Blue Jays are ahead. The Rays are in fourth as far as where they're picked to finish. And Vegas has them at 84.5
Vegas has the Blue Jays over the Rays.
Yeah. And they've got the win total for the Rays.
I don't see that at all.
84.5, Doug.
I don't see that at all. I don't trust we were talking about the Blue Jays, and they're coming in. So this is good. You know, they're coming in. Is a four game, right? Yeah, Thursday through Sunday. And then we got Texas right after that. It's actually the first two series that we play are good tests for the Tampa
World
Bay
Series
Rays.
Champions.
It's going to be really good. I don't really trust where the Blue Jays lineup is. I don't think it's as deep as a lot of people are considering it to be. I think there's some big names in there. But I think after you get through the 4-5 spots, it's not going to be that great at the bottom of that order. And we'll see where the injuries take that rotation. They got Barrios going game one. He's good. He's really good. But they are missing some arms in the bullpen. So we'll see. I just don't see them. They've always had talent. They've just never been able to put it together. So I don't have them in front of the Rays by any means.
I'm honestly more pessimistic about the Rays than I've been in probably years.
Because of offense, defense, pitching, what is it?
Yeah.
No,
a little bit of everything.
We got the best bullpen in the league. And we use the bullpen more than anyone else.
I agree with you with the bullpen, and it's part of the reason why I'm not just completely pessimistic. I'm more pessimistic than I've been in a long time when it comes to the Rays. And the reality is, I don't know how to get past that, but even with that said, I can't see a scenario where they're in fourth place. Like, I just can't.
Well, pessimistic is what? That they end up in third? But you just said the Yankees aren't going to
overtake
them.
Win the division last year, right? I was wrong. They didn't win the division.
What's pessimistic
for
you?
88 wins for me.
That's probably still in the playoffs.
Yeah. I don't think they're going to be bad. I trust this organization, Kevin Cash, way too much to think they're going to be as good as last year or even 2 years ago. I struggle to get there.
Let me say, it's so awesome that you can be pessimistic, and when you think about it, and you personally are thinking down on the Rays, you still have them in the playoffs.
Yeah, well, Pat's a good guy.
Yeah.
He's a really pessimistic. He's an optimistic guy at all times. I just recently became.
I know you like the way he says that with such negativity.
Well, no, because I'm not. And
that was not a compliment to
you. No, it is, because you know what I am now? Just recently, I'm a half glass full guy.
No, you're not.
I am now.
No, you're not.
I'm trying to be.
So hold up, dude. half glass full, so you mean an empty glass that's cut in half?
That's how you look at it.
Glass half full. You're saying half glass full.
Glass half full.
It's glass half full. Yeah. You said half glass full.
No, I didn't.
You said half glass full.
Oh, whatever. I'm a half glass, glass half glass. Glass now's gone.
Okay.
Glass now's gone. You by the boo-boo, don't it? Either way, I'm optimistic in life.
Glass?
You know what I'm happy about, guys? I'm happy to be able to talk to you guys about International Diamond Center, because you know what? IDC is simply the best. Aaron was actually just over there yesterday looking at some of their gorgeous watches, but whether you're thinking about a new Rolex or if you're buying any kind of jewelry or getting engaged or celebrating something huge this year, IDC is going to hook you up. I love their selection. They've got the largest selection of hand-picked certified diamonds in all of Florida. All the top designers, all the top jewelry that women are asking for, all the famous engagement ring brands. They're all at IDC. So many things that you can't get anywhere else. I also love the fact that it's just so laid back. Aaron was talking about it yesterday. He was in there. The guy didn't recognize him, but he treated him just like anyone else. And when I say that, that's about as good as you can be treated anywhere. And that's what we love about IDC. And their laid-back approach, it's just unmatched. They're non-commissioned salespeople. They're going to teach you about what you're looking at, not pressure you into buying something. There's no tricks, no games, no nonsense, just a relaxed and informative shopping experience.
And I love that they have something for everyone, whether you're looking for an engagement ring, something expensive, because they have that there as well. But if you're looking for something extremely affordable for you, they've got that too. I was looking at their heart Manhattan, Florida collection yesterday. Some beautiful necklaces. So make sure you stop in, check them out. And then I was looking at the Rolexes, and I was talking to some of the guys there. The Rolexes are flying off the shelves there. People love the Rolexes, and you can get them and check them out over at International Diamond Center. But the value there, like I said, it cannot be matched. They have the best, lowest, most attractive prices around, period, all across the board. Their connections in the diamond industry, they're unmatched. So check them out. International Diamond Center, we're talking about the total package here. They are internationally connected, locally owned. They can provide the kind of local attention and service that you want and need. They're right down the street, the location from us right here, but they've also got one in Tampa, Lakeland, and Sarasota. We're in Clearwater right now. Check them out. Mom and pop stores, they can't compete with this. And the big national chains, they can't compete either. International Diamond Center, it is the place to be. Check them out, shopidc.com.
Check out Casey Warner and some of the things we've missed during today's show in the blender. That's coming up on the other side. A very baseball blender on a Wector Wednesday with Doug Wector in the house on 95.3 WDAE and AM 620.
Tomorrow is opening day. Join WDAE live from Tropicana Field as we stay live and local from the sunrise to first pitch of the home slate. All right. On the radio home of the Tampa Bay Rays, 95.3 WDAE and AM 620. Streaming live on Alexa and the free iHeartRadio app. Presented by the Central Florida Behavioral Health Network and the Department of Children and Families. WDAE with What's Up Tampa Bay.
Bowl with Crash and AJ at 98 Rocks. Bowling for balls at Pin Chasers on April 13th. For tickets and more info, visit 98rock.com. Join us April 5th through 7th at Armature Works in the Heights District for the WFLA News Channel 8 Outdoors Expo and Boat Show. Admission is free all weekend. Visit WFLA.com/Outdoors Expo for more details.
Stay on top of everything going on at 953WDAE.com.
I'm John Morgan. When you call Morgan & Morgan, America's largest injury law firm, your very own army springs into action immediately, 24/7. Our investigators, legal staff, and over 900 lawyers work together to fight to get you the best result as quickly and easily as possible. Insurance companies know who we are, and now you know it too. This firm was built for greatness. This firm was built for you. Injured? Call your army. We're ready to roll. Morgan & Morgan. Visit ForThePeople.com for an office near you.
Rivard Buick GMC, the number three. Wait a minute. I got that wrong there. Rivard Buick GMC, the number two GMC dealer in the country. That's right. Rivard Buick GMC is now the number two GMC dealer in the entire country. How'd they get there? Well, massive inventory, which means you've got options. Insane discounts you just won't see these days. Go to RivardBuickGMC.com and see for yourself. And last but not least, a staff to help you get through the car buying process start to finish. Visit RivardBuickGMC.com today. GMC. We are professional grade.
This Easter weekend, hop on over to Pool Perfection's grand opening of their second location. With 20 years of experience and top-notch quality, they're bringing the best to North Tampa communities. Just 2 miles west of the Tampa Premium Outlets on State Road 54. Join the festivities this Saturday, 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. and Sunday from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. Indulge in delicious food and exciting fun as you explore what Pool Perfection has to offer. Plus, for those attending, there are fantastic incentives in store if you're considering building that pool. Don't miss out on the treats this weekend. Come celebrate with Pool Perfection.
The tournament is here. Bet Online is your bracket headquarters for this season with the best bracket contest out there and odds, lines, and info on every game and every round right up until the national championship. You can access the most up-to-the-minute wagering information anytime from your desktop or your mobile device and even track your bracket real-time all the way through the tournament. Head to Bet Online today to stay updated on all the action. Bet Online. The game starts here.
Planning for spring at Lowe's means big savings on outdoor power equipment. And Lowe's knows nothing feels better than free. Buy one select Ego string trimmer, leaf blower, or mower kit. Get one select 56-volt battery free. That's up to a $299 value. Power through spring with Ego, the number one rated brand in cordless outdoor power. Because Lowe's knows home improvement. Valid through 4/3 while supplies last. Selection varies by location.
Celebrate and save at Ashley's Anniversary Sale. With Hot Buys, your choice of colors starting at just $3.99. Ashley Sleep Mattresses starting at $2.50. Plus, receive a free adjustable base with select mattress purchases. And shop top mattress brands like Stearns & Foster, Tempur-Pedic, Purple, and Beautyrest Black with 60-month special financing only at Ashley. Subject to credit approval, no minimum purchase required. Minimum monthly payment, down payment, tax, and delivery may be required. See store for details.
Some things in life you can just rely on, like the comfy fit of a favorite pair of jeans and the tried and true performance of a new AC system from Rood. So here's to reliability, built into everything we do. Rely on Rood. Get reliable cooling and comfort installed by a certified Rood Pro Partner. Go to RoodACFlorida.com to schedule service with a Rood Pro Partner today. That's RoodACFlorida.com. Powered locally by Ferguson HVAC.
Broadcasting from the Rood Air Conditioning Studios, this is Tampa Bay Sports Radio, 95.3 WDAE and AM 620, home of the best Bolts coverage. The Blender.
The Blender on the Pat Aaron Show is presented by Mazda of Clearwater. If you're thinking about a new or even pre-owned vehicle, the choice is clear. It is Mazda of Clearwater. Mr. Warner, let's blend it up, young man.
Blend it up. Here we go. First topic was a call I just got from Chris in St. Pete. So shout out to Chris in St. Pete for the very timely topic. With the injuries that the Rays have sustained on their starting rotation, the question was asked, why haven't they looked at Trevor Bauer and why haven't they signed him to a minor league deal?
So we talked about this the other day. Aaron was adamant about bringing Trevor in. I think it's a good idea as well. I don't know which team is going to make the move. I feel like eventually someone will. Doug Wechter, of course, if you're just tuning in studio with us on a Wechter Wednesday, where do you come down on Trevor Bauer? Obviously, a bit of an odd guy, but also
such a dangerous question.
I
love answering it.
Would you be open-minded?
You know, first of all, if no one in the big leagues is giving him a shot, there's probably a reason why, right?
Like there's more that we don't know.
I don't know. But, I mean, you know, he's got the resume, right? Between the lines, this is a guy who could really help any staff. But do you want to add that to your clubhouse?
I do.
That's the thing. And most teams are very aware of what you're bringing in the clubhouse. Now, remember, this is a guy who, before anything came out, was questioned as a clubhouse guy.
Yeah.
So I think that plays a factor into all this as well.
Put
right?
a gag order on him. Say you can't speak in the clubhouse.
That's
we're
the
sign
thing
you
is like you're bringing a lot of attention into a clubhouse, and what are you getting in return?
Get him an interpreter.
I also said to Aaron yesterday, I think it was yesterday, it's very difficult when you're maybe in the Rays situation as much as anyone else and the last year that they've had to bring in a guy that's got some questionable stuff.
Yeah.
It's true.
Yeah.
I think
it's kind of a polarizing figure in the media.
Yeah.
And you want to add that to a rotation where you know you're going to get, first of all, you know you're going to get Shane Boz back. You know you're going to get Jeffrey Springs back. So these guys are coming back at least maybe around All-Star break. So you're talking about piecing together a first half of a season. And you're doing with guys that they trust, man. They really like Tyler Alexander. They like some of these other guys, Wagespack, what they've seen. And, you know, they've been really good when they put together bullpen days or opener days. You look at the record over the last 4 or 5 years. I mean, why go out there and bring somebody in that you don't know if it's going to be a good fit when you got guys internally that you can do?
And my thing is, it's a low risk, high reward type of move. He'll play for pennies. And there are other guys in the league that have been accused of domestic violence,
right?
Aroldis Chapman, who, by the way, pitched for the World Series champion Texas Rangers last year.
And groped his mother like last week on the internet. So, like, there's always that, too, with Aroldis Chapman.
Okay. For people
Trevor
that didn't
Bauer.
See that, I guess there's no follow-up.
Well, they
on
can
that.
Google it. They can Google it. Like, he groped his mom. How much more do you need to know?
I have a lot of questions.
Next question, Casey. Casey, let's move on.
Trevor Bauer has not been signed, but one Jordan Montgomery has been signed by the Diamondbacks on a 1-year, $25 million deal. Does this automatically put the Diamondbacks back in the running for a best National League team?
No.
Best National League team?
No.
Not by any means.
Yeah.
They might be a playoff team, but
maybe.
There's by no means are they even close to the best.
They might not be a playoff
team. I mean, look, the Dodgers are going to – the Dodgers, the Braves, there's multiple teams that right off the bat you're like, wait a second. They're, you know, even with Jordan Montgomery, which I thought – a couple other teams. I thought Baltimore was going to go after him. I mean, I know the ownership group and the turnover and all that stuff. I thought they were going to try to land that dude.
In that division, you might have the Padres. You might have the Giants to finish ahead of the Diamondbacks. Like, I don't know. I think it's going to be a tough one to repeat what they did in the playoffs.
Look, I think it's a good move for the Diamondbacks. I don't think it puts them over the edge.
Can I ask you a question, Doug, about this specifically? Because we were talking about it earlier. These 1 year contracts for guys, these small contracts, 1-2 years for guys, the names Blake Snell and Jordan Montgomery, big names. Is that, in a way, can the Rays look at that mold and maybe capitalize in the future? Obviously, they weren't going to sign a guy long-term, $25 million a year, but I think 20 to 25 a year, they didn't quite go that much with Charlie Morton, but they kind of did a similar thing with Charlie.
What did we sign Eflin for? He was one of our most
44, I think.
Right, so
like that.
I want to say that was the biggest contract we've given to a starter up to that point. So they do go out there and they look for certain guys that they can put into 2 and 3 year deals that they feel like there's a ton of upside. They're just very calculated at those moves. And, of course, with Eflin, it worked out great. I mean, they are so calculated on every single move. They got to know the return is going to be exactly what they need. And so that's why we saw Zach Eflin do what he did last year. That's why we saw him get a contract from the Rays. And the good thing is a lot of these pitchers want to come to Tampa Bay because of the reputation Kyle Snyder has and the rest of the team has. So I would never put it against the Rays putting together, deals like that, but it's got to be very calculated. It's got to be the right guy.
The Rays are always looking for upside. If you're looking for upside in the housing market, we'll let Doug Wechter tell you in a few minutes where you might be able to find some of that. And a guy he knows that can certainly help you in that case. But maybe you're looking to lose some weight before you buy that new home. We know the people that can help you there as well. That's our friends at Age Rejuvenation. We've been telling you, John Mamola, he's using their semaglutide program, which can give you a real boost if you're looking to lose a lot of weight and a lot of weight fast. I'm going with just diet and exercise because I'm losing weight a little bit more gradually. But however you want to go about it, Age Rejuvenation can build the perfect weight loss program for you. So whether you need that boost and you want to lose a lot of weight fast or you just want to lose a little bit weight or lose it a little more gradually, they can build the perfect program for you. Just go to agerejuvenation.com. If you tell them I sent you, they'll give you 50% off your first month. Agerejuvenation.com.
WDAE. Traffic update.
Seeing delays in St. Pete, southbound 275, south of Gandy to 38th Avenue North. Delays in Tarpon Springs on southbound US 19 from before Tarpon Avenue towards Klosterman and southbound 75 in Hillsborough County. A bit slow south of Brucey Downs to pass Fowler Avenue. Northbound 75, it's slow near Big Bend Road and westbound I-4 from before the Selman Connector over towards 275. With traffic, I'm Randy Myers.
This report is sponsored by Fresh from Florida.
Meal planning is work, so let Fresh from Florida help. Learn what's in season, browse hundreds of recipes, and get tips from Chef Justin by visiting freshfromflorida.com. Eat healthier with Fresh from Florida. There's sunshine in every bite.
I feel good.
Dad, are you singing to your cereal?
Yes, I am, like I knew that I would.
No, a dance too?
Come on, Ava. Silk almond milk starts the morning on a high note.
Yow! Songs, dances, and dad jokes?
So good! So good! I got you!
Silk almond milk.
With calcium, vitamins A, D, and E.
Feel plenty good.
A fraction of a raindrop, 3 grains of salt. At up to 100 times more potent than morphine, the tiniest amount of illegal fentanyl is all it takes to cause an overdose. Fentanyl can be mixed into heroin, cocaine, pressed pills, meth, and other drugs. It could be in your drugs, and you wouldn't be able to see it, taste it, or smell it. Learn more at cdc.gov/stopoverdose.
Guys, your perfect closet starts with the right finishing touches. And right now, during the light and accessory event at California Closets, every $1,500 of design, lighting, and accessories you buy earns you $500 toward your custom design. Garage, office, bedroom, California Closets will give you the space that's fresh, styled, and expertly organized. To get started, visit one of their 3 conveniently located showrooms or visit CaliforniaClosetsTampaBay.com to book your free design consultation today. Tell them T-Craz sent you.
Join us for our 2024 iHeartRadio Music Awards, live from the Dolby Theater in Hollywood.
Monday, April 1st. Watch on Fox, starting at 8 p.m. And listen on the free iHeartRadio app.
Oh, 10.
Tesla Apprentalast is a proud partner of the iHeartRadio Music Awards, a celebration of artists and the fans who got them there. The fans who make the music truly come alive through their energy and positive vibes. To the fans that make live music possible, we salute you.
Enjoy lunch or dinner today at Kelly's Roast Beef, the iconic taste of Boston, home of the original roast beef sandwich. Plus, authentic New England seafood, chicken sandwiches, burgers, dogs, ice cream, kids' meals, and more. All freshly made with gluten-free options, too. Dine in or drive through today at Kelly's Roast Beef. Mention this ad and get a free Kelly scratch card for special discounts or free food. Stop by today at University and Honoree in Sarasota and just northeast of Pasadena and Shore Drive in St. Pete. Kelly's Roast Beef.
This March, it's time to join the winning team for your home loan needs. HowardTeamHomeLoans.com. Homeowners' debt is madness with credit card rates going through the roof. So find out how John Howard and his team can save you right now at HowardTeamHomeLoans.com.
Lower LLC, NMLS, 1124061. Equal housing opportunity. Terms and conditions apply.
I'm John Morgan of Morgan & Morgan. Today, we're the largest injury firm in the world, and I'm thankful to you for trusting us all these years. We'll always be here for the people, not the powerful. We'll always be here for you. Morgan & Morgan.
Visit ForThePeople.com for an office near you.
Trajan Wealth, your trusted local fiduciary advisors. Visit TrajanWealth.com.
This report is sponsored by Allstate. Some people just know the best rate for you is a rate based on you with Allstate, not one based on anyone else. So if you drive safely, you could save money. Good to know. Visit Allstate.com or call for a quote today.
Mix of sun and cloud today. Heavier on the cloud side. Slight chance of rain as well. Our high about 84. Overnight, mostly cloudy. Chance of thunderstorms, 70% chance. Our low drops down to 71. Thursday, much the same. Mostly cloudy, 70% chance of early day showers. We should see the sun in the afternoon. Our high right around 77.
Dan Patrick coming up at 9 a.m. Jay and Z at noon. You're locked on Tampa Bay Sports Radio. WDAE.
Pat Aaron, 95.3 WDAE and AM 620. Luckily for Doug Wechter, I've already asked him one uncomfortable thing on the radio today. Yeah. So I won't jump into the next uncomfortable thing I want to ask him right now. But... yeah, again, luckily for you, Doug Wechter. We've got a few minutes left, though, and I was saying before the break, if somebody is looking for a new home, you might be able to help out. Doug Wechter can on social media, the best way to get a hold of you.
It is, yes,
turning
social
in a
media.
Good way or a bad
turning
way?
In a good way for buyers, I think. I think it's definitely, you're seeing a lot more, well, I wouldn't say a lot more, you're seeing more inventory on the market. It's going to change a lot over the next 3 to 5 months, in my opinion, and just continuing to go into a buyer's type of market, not there yet, but that's the trend we're seeing for sure.
To tie this back into the Rays and baseball a little bit, right? We have been pretty certain that this thing is a done deal when it comes to the new stadium. And then recently, some people with St. Pete and the commissioners and some of these folks that need to vote on it, they're not showing any kind of urgency at all. Is that going to impact real estate? Like, if this thing gets a little further down the road, does that start to impact real estate, in your opinion?
Well, hopefully it won't. Hopefully we're able to figure all this stuff out. I don't know enough about the details between the city and the team, but, I think at this point everybody's just rooting for them to stay and a deal to get done, right? Whether you were on the Tampa side, the St. Pete side, Clearwater, wherever you're at, I think everybody is on the same side when you want the team to stay in the Tampa Bay area. Right now, it looks like St. Pete is the best option. So hopefully they find a way to make that happen and get that done quickly, because you're going to have to start building a stadium here pretty quick.
Have to.
Yeah. And so all that being said, of course it's going to impact real estate, especially downtown St. Pete. I mean, it's going to be a huge impact because they're redeveloping over 90 acres. And where else?
But I'm saying, like, let's say you want to sell your house later this year, right? And the vote is supposed to happen before late this year.
Well, the development's going to happen either way. Like, they're going to develop that entire area. The hope is that there's a deal struck and the Rays will be on that site. And I still think it gets done. It's just, these are such big negotiations that take a long time. This is not a small negotiation going on. I mean, you're talking a lot of money, a big transaction, and a lot of different angles to it. So you just got to kind of let it play out. The one thing is that it plays out in the media, so everybody watches these happening. And I'm still very confident it gets done and they stay.
I'm not very confident, but I'm confident that they will get it done and they will stay. Did you see some of the food coming to the trial?
So short rib nachos.
Boy,
and short rib pulled, short rib Philly cheesesteaks.
Did you see the Korean?
Oh, that's good.
When
be
I heard
sick.
That, I was like, first of all, you can't eat both those on the same day. You could attempt.
Yes, you can.
You could attempt.
Yes, you can.
But I'm going to take short rib all of them down.
What about the Korean corn dog?
I'm going to try it.
There you are.
There's nothing in that trop that I will not try. I'm going to try to some of the menu items they have coming in this year. It's got me excited.
Read the description of the Korean corn dog.
Here's the description I'm seeing from Angie Andrews of Bay News 9. Korean corn dog.
Oh, all right, cool.
And it's $40, right? $40
no.
The description. Corn dog.
Relax I'd over there, it. Warner. I'll buy you a corn dog.
Oh, it's just a hot dog. You just want to try them in any capacity.
Yeah, I do. And I'm a big corn dog guy. When I go to the fair.
What's the hot dog count up to? Did you count spring training?
I got two in the training.
Oh, you are way behind. What's the over-under? 100?
Behind. 100. I'll catch up tomorrow. I'll be at 10.
No, you got to eat them inside the trop, though.
So it's counted zero.
Yeah, so you're at zero, all and right, you're going to eat 100 hot dogs inside the trop. This season, regular season.
I'm going to think I'm going to go to about 30 games or so. Maybe
so you
got to
go
more.
3+ a game?
That's a big pace. I might take the under. I don't want to get sick this year.
Have you ever eaten 4 in a day? Okay, so what if we set the over-under at 90?
I'll go over that.
You are the most inconsistent human being.
Can you put a poll together? Is Aaron going to eat more hot dogs than the Rays get wins? I said it at 93.
I think it's very close.
I said 93.
How am I inconsistent? It's in the trop.
Because here's the thing. You'll eat food that's been left out on the counter overnight, and then you're like, oh, I don't want to eat too many hot dogs this year because I don't want to get sick.
No, because
that body's a temple.
I realized last year that, like, it's not the fat. I'm hungry, but if I eat too many hot dogs, like, any person's going to get sick unless your name's Joey Chestnut. That guy's a freak.
Yeah. He's your mentor.
He's my hero.
Yeah.
He's my hero.
Hey, by the way, Casey, free hot dogs in the press box, so don't be
Let's
so angry.
Let's go. Yeah. No, I'm not angry. It's just an observation.
He looked angry all day.
I can't get a beer for less than 25, so it's all right.
You got to get a Camelback with the beer instead of water.
We'll teach you the beer trick, too, Casey Warner. Don't you worry. That's all we have time for today for Doug Wechter in for us. Thank you, Doug. It's always fun.
Of course.
For Aaron Jacobson, I'm Pat Donovan. Casey Warner in the penalty box. Thanks so much to the men and women who serve our country and allow us to be morons for a living. Don't miss us live from the Trop tomorrow for opening day. I know we got Richie Palacios on the show. We'll see who else shows up. That's next.
That's tomorrow next. When Doug Wechter calls you a big guy to start the day, it's just a great day. It's going to be a great day. And if he tells you otherwise, he's not telling the truth. He called me big guy, tapped me on the shoulder. Let's go, Goons. I'll see you at the Hard Rock today.
Don't miss a minute of the Pat and Aaron Show. Head to the Pat and Aaron Show blog at 95.3WDAE.com and stream 95.3 WDAE on the free iHeartRadio app or on your Alexa. Just say, Alexa, play 95.3 WDAE on iHeartRadio. Stay tuned. The Dan Patrick Show is next. Live on 95.3 WDAE and AM 620.
What sets International Diamond Center apart from those big box jewelry chain stores?
The problem with big chain stores is that they're all run by corporate.
IDC owner Keith LeClaire.
That means the people at the store level just plain don't care much.
At IDC, you're not dealing with a bunch of retail clerks. You're working with a professional who's not on commission and not beholden to a bunch of corporate dictated rules and policies.
When you're in the big corporate world, everybody operates out of a manual or a big book of rules. At IDC, we don't have a manual telling our people how to deal with customers. We empower our people to take care of those customers in the way they would want to be taken care of.
Get the respect, guidance, professionalism, and genuine care you deserve from people who put you first.
We tell them point blank, do whatever it takes to make the customer happy, period.
International Diamond Center, locally owned, internationally connected.
We want them to take care of you, protect you, and make it the best experience that you could possibly have.
In Tampa, Clearwater, Lakeland, and Sarasota, and always at shopidc.com.
Hey, it's Brett from Bull Oak. Are you struggling from erectile dysfunction? We've got a groundbreaking solution that's transformed the lives of thousands of men. Our WAVE technology is backed by 50 clinical studies, including research from prestigious Cambridge University. It revitalizes blood flow by repairing blood vessels. all without the need for pills or the worry of side effects. If you're ready to end your erectile dysfunction struggles, call us now. Not only will you get a free assessment and blood flow ultrasound, we're also throwing in your first treatment free on us. That's right. Give us a call and schedule an appointment, and we'll get you your first treatment free. This is a $600 value, and it's yours free if you call in the next 2 minutes. Call 813-219-1919. That's 813-219-1919. Guys, it's time to reclaim your love life and put an end to your erectile dysfunction. Call 813-219-1919. Call Bull Oak now to qualify. 813-219-1919.
Hi, I'm Benny Jr. with Bartow Ford. The college basketball playoffs have always been one of my favorite times of the sporting year. Why? It's a chance for a small-town school to beat a perennial powerhouse. Bartow Ford has been that underdog, outselling big-city dealerships every single day, every single year. We only do this by teamwork and taking care of our customers. It's just another way at Bartow Ford we're different, and we prove it.
Aaron Jacobson here, and spring has officially sprung for the used car market, and you know what that means? Full tilt boogie time at GiveMeTheVIN.com. Looking to sell your car, truck, or SUV? GiveMeTheVIN.com. They make selling your vehicle fast and easy, and that's all we want in this world, for things to be simple. GiveMeTheVIN.com. They're A-plus rated by the BBB for a reason. Go check them out. When you log on to GiveMeTheVIN.com, you're going to see why satisfied customers across the country, they're putting more money in their pocket by just going to GiveMeTheVIN.com. They want to buy your vehicle right now. So go to GiveMeTheVIN.com, put in your VIN number, a few pictures, and get ready. Yes, it is just that easy. If GiveMeTheVIN.com can't beat your CarMax offer, they'll pay you $100, period, just like that. So check them out. Log on to GiveMeTheVIN.com, put in your VIN or license number, a couple pictures, and get that instant cash offer. 60-second bid process, pressure-free service, and free pickup. GiveMeTheVIN.com and get your check on the spot.
Ew. Gotta get rid of this old Backstreet Boys t-shirt.
Tell me why.
Because it stinks, boys.
Tell me why.
I've washed it so many times, but the odor won't come out.
Tell me why.
No, you tell me why I can't get rid of this odor.
Have you tried Downy Rinse and Refresh? It doesn't just cover up odors. It helps remove them.
Wow, it worked, guys.
Yeah.
Downy Rinse and Refresh removes more odor in one wash than the leading value detergent in three washes. Find it wherever you buy laundry products.
We sold our home for substantially more than we bought it for and skipped the costly renovations to fix up our home. Thank you, Mark Spain Real Estate. Hey, it's Aaron Jacobson here, and Mark Spain Real Estate, they're helping homeowners just like our listener, Caitlin, there, sell their homes fast and for maximum profit. If you're like Caitlin, you're ready to take advantage of this hot real estate market. My friends at Mark Spain Real Estate, they're the most trusted and experienced real estate team in the country. Find out what the guaranteed offer on your home will be today. There's no obligation. Go to markspain.com, get a guaranteed offer. That's markspain.com, and start packing.
The free iHeartRadio app has over 100 commercial free stations waiting for you to explore right now, like Freeform Radio, a unique blend of Americana, classic alternative, and roots rock. The free iHeartRadio app, search Freeform Radio, and listen now, commercial free. Free never sounded so good.
Stuck in traffic? Signal cutting out? Get online. Download the free iHeartRadio app.
You can take WDAE and your home for sports, music, talk, and podcasts all in one app.
Free never sounded so good.
Presented by the law offices of Anajar and Levine, accident attorneys.
Call 1-800-747-FREE.
That's 1-800-747-3733.
Portions of the following program were pre-recorded.
We're the most trusted voices in Tampa Bay sports. Call home.
We are 620 WTAE St. Petersburg, 95.3 FM W237 CW Pinellas Park, 95.7 HD3 WBTP Clearwater, 96.7 FM W224 BE Brandon.
Streaming live on the free iHeartRadio app.
Listen for all your music, sports, talk, and podcasts.
Free never sounded so good.
So good. So good. So good.
You're out, you're about, but you want your Dan Patrick. Well, good news, he goes everywhere with you. If you miss the show, you can podcast it. If you want to see the show, just go to Peacock, and we stream it live every weekday. Watch past episodes, too. The Dan Patrick Show, available anywhere you are, any way you want it. Welcome to the Dan Patrick Show.
My job is to be curious and suspicious.
Bringing you the biggest guests and best interviews in the world of sports.
It's tricky to get into, oh, baseball should suspend it. Okay, why?
So I never bet on baseball or any other sports, or never have asked somebody to do it on my behalf. And I have never went through a bookmaker.
And maybe he was duped.
When I look at Ohtani, he is big time. But the fact that you got a foreign player that needs an interpreter, I think contributes to harming the game to some degree.
Obviously not the intention, but that certainly aged well.
Broadcasting from the Mercedes Man Cave, it's Dan Patrick.
Well, it's hour one on a Wednesday. Morale is high. It's always nice to walk in and the Traeger grills were fired up. And I go, well, wait a minute. It's a Wednesday. We normally do Meat Friday. Well, the big Germans out there whipping up a batch. We have French toast. We have eggs. We have sausage. All on the Traeger. Who has it better than we do?
Nobody.
Yes. Good stuff. Thank you, Eric, the big German. Celebrity Bracket Challenge. Standings for our Bracket Challenge powered by NetSuite. They're available at foxsportsradio.com. First hour brought to you by Express Employment Professionals. They want to help you get a job, and they're not going to charge you. Job seekers never pay a fee at Express. Check out expresspros.com. Find the location nearest you. That's expresspros.com. Good morning if you're watching on Peacock. Thank you, our streaming partner. By the way, Peacock is going to have another NFL game coming up. It was just announced that that first weekend, that Friday game, will be in Brazil. So you're going to have Thursday and then Friday, and then you'll have Sunday games, and then a Sunday night game. And then, Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas to everybody but Adam Silver in the NBA, because you're going to have a couple of NFL games on a Wednesday on Christmas Day. You imagine the commissioner of the NBA? He's already dealing with this nonsense with Jonte Porter in Toronto and betting on his under-over stats, and the NFL comes out with a hammer. Hey, you guys usually have Christmas Day. The NBA owns Christmas Day. Nah, I don't think so. Not anymore. So much so, Christmas on a Wednesday, we're going to put not one but two NFL games. There are going to be teams playing three games in 13 days. The NFL likes to tell us that they're all about player safety, but they're a business. And the players understand this as well. But three games, 13 days, I think that's above and beyond the call of duty. Not exactly a, let me put this in your stocking there, guys. And we're going to go to 18 games. The question is not if, but when. But the NFL making news, as they always do, it doesn't matter. Whenever they want to, they can knock anybody out of the headlines. It's like Shohei Ohtani. Yeah, why don't you sit down for a little while? The women's tournament, men's tournament. Yeah, you can hold off. Let the big boys come in. We got some news here. They changed the kickoff, which I like, because if you said I can have something that's a little gimmicky, but still has a return attached to it and some excitement, that's better than a touchback. And I know that you get the purist who go, oh, I don't even recognize football anymore. Well, try. Because you know what they're doing? They're trying new things. I probably have people going, can you believe they're going to let them wear a face mask? I mean, what are they thinking? You know, 1955, come on. It's not the way we did it. But the NFL is trying new things. That's why they have these developmental leagues, so they can try new things. Camera angles, you know, certain plays that you can do. I think they're still going to try to do something to modify the punt return, because once again, the collisions, the number of injuries. Now, the most violent play is still the kickoff. They're going to try to cut back on that with the amount of speed you can build up running into people. But at least it's better than having a touchback. But I did find some people on social media that they were appalled that this is what the NFL is doing. Okay. You going to still watch? Yeah, I thought you would. Or you get this. Oh, the NFL, come on. Two games on Christmas Day? That's too much. You going to watch? Yeah, but, you know, I feel bad for the NBA. Okay, you can flip around. It's survival of the fittest. That's what this is. The NFL has taken over the world. hey, we're going to put a game in Brazil, one in Germany, we're going to put a couple in London. I mean, this is, and I don't think they're looking at expansion. I think what they're looking at, if I'm the owner of a team, let's say I'm the Eagles, well, we want to have a country that is ours. We want to own Germany. Or, you know, Kansas City Chiefs, I think, want to own Germany. The Steelers in Ireland are talking about that. New England Patriots, they, I think, we're talking about, could they own Germany? That's what you want. And now if you're the Eagles, hey, we want to own Brazil. Okay. You get those fan bases there. They buy your merchandise. You're the official team of that country. Yeah, Paulie. Or yes, Seton.
So that gives what you just said right there gives sheds new light on the idea that the Patriots game earlier last season in Germany was their Super Bowl.
Yes.
This is the biggest game, and we're all kind of like, what are you talking about? That's the dumbest thing I ever heard. Why is this game so important? I don't know, maybe that's why.
Yeah, that you want to own that country. You want to go in there and be the official team, and you're building a fan base. This isn't a case of, hey, are we going to have a team in London or a team in Scotland or Ireland or Germany or Brazil or Mexico City? I thought that for a long time, but I don't think that now. I think that you're just allowing these teams, if they want to give up a home game, that they will give it up. And in return, you can become the official team of that country. All right. 877-3DP show. Email address dp@danpatrick.com. Twitter handle @DP Show. Operator Tyler standing by to take your phone calls. Mike Tannenbaum caused a stir yesterday. ESPN front office insider gave us his mock draft. And woo, we got quarterbacks galore and a trade where Arizona would take a quarterback, J.J. McCarthy, and then trade Kyler Murray to Minnesota. So Mike T. will join us coming up a little bit later on. And we will look at the kickoff and the strategy of the new rule. We're going to do that a little bit later on as well. John Calipari is coming back to Kentucky, and he says that he needs to change, do some things differently, obviously. I don't know if he's going to go transfer portal crazy here because he normally brings in a pretty good class of recruits. I don't know what his recruiting class, you know, if are they in the top five again? I'm guessing. Yeah, Paulie.
There's two. They're one and two with Duke. It flip-flops. But, yeah, it's Kentucky and Duke had the top two recruiting classes. But, again, they're all 18-year-olds.
And I was also looking at this. I was wondering because I'm watching OKC play the Pelicans. Oklahoma City, the NBA team, has an average age. Their starting lineup is 22.6 years. So Shai Gilgeous-Alexander's 25, Lu Dort, 24, Jalen Williams, 22, Chet Holmgren, 21, Josh Giddey, 21. And then I started to wonder, how old is North Carolina's roster in this year's tournament? Well, North Carolina's average age, their starting five, is 22.3 years. Oklahoma City's starting lineup, average age is 22.6.
Woo! Ow! Stat of the day! Stat of the day! Stat of the day! Stat of the day! This is the stat of the day!
Stat of the day, brought to you by Panini America, the official trading cards of the Dan Patrick Show. So John Calipari is coming back. And it feels like you're on double secret probation. Because if you don't win the SEC and or you bow out early in the tournament, and then here we are again, it just feels like that's when the AD is going to go, John, we tried. Got a lot of guys in the NBA making a lot of money. We want to make money here at Kentucky as well. Yes, Eden.
I'm curious how much he changes his recruiting philosophy now for this upcoming year.
Well, it doesn't sound like he is if he's bringing in all these recruits. They're high school kids.
Yeah,
I don't know how many transfer portals. Now, he's going to have probably three first-round picks from this year's roster. Yes, Marv?
Yeah, that's what I was going to ask. Do you think he's going to try to convince some of those players to stay another year? All right, maybe you're a fringe first-round pick. Just stay here for another year and develop and then hopefully help me win some more games.
Yeah, but you want to get into that rookie deal. That's why you come out early, you get in, and then you knock that rookie deal out, and then that's when you start to make $30, $40 million. And that's what these kids want to do. But I imagine, you know, he's always been good. He's fair to say, you know, now's the time to go. And, you know, basically I'm going to have to push you out the door. I think he's been respectable to these players in a bigger picture. But that was part of his selling point, that he would sell these recruits on, look at what I've done. And these recruits are basically, this is a rest stop on the highway to getting $30, $40, $50 million a year. Hey, I'll just pull in here, spend 6 months at Kentucky, then I'm going to the NBA because, hey, that's what everybody does at Kentucky. You know, Cal doesn't get guys who stay much longer than that. And if they do, then you wonder, like, what's wrong? Man, he's been here 2 years. That's an eternity at Kentucky. I don't know if, can he change it in 1 year? Can he go out in a transfer portal, and who are you bringing in? And did you promise these recruits coming in, hey, you're going to be my starting point guard? Imagine you get there, and all of a sudden you got a guy who played at Cal and averaged 18 points, and you brought him in to play point guard. Then all of a sudden, those recruits will be a little unrest there because they're only there for 6 months. Then they're gonzo. Yeah, Paul.
You almost wish Calipari could tell the high school all-star recruits, go play at Drake, go play at Southern Illinois for 2 years, build yourself up, then we'll transfer you in.
Seton, what's poll question today?
Well, I think we're going to go with the NFL topic. You were just hitting that because we were all pretty, we had a good discussion about it before the show. But can there be too much NFL?
All right, let's go around the room here. Who thinks having two games on a Wednesday that happens to be Christmas is too much? Todd?
I do. I think it's it doesn't need to have an NFL game. And I love the NFL every day of the week, and enforcing it on a Wednesday, it just makes it, I don't know, that could be the NBA's day, and I would be very comfortable watching hoops and then going right back to the NFL.
Seton, what about you?
Yeah, I know I'm definitely not the typical sports fan, certainly not the typical football fan either. Mm-hmm. But yeah, I would definitely, for me, I don't need football every night of the week.
Yeah. I appreciate it when it's on. You know, some matchups you're probably not looking forward to, but if I can take a break from, you know, people in the family tree who might be over for Christmas, where I go, hon, I got to watch this game. Well, we got, it's Christmas. We have, I know, but I have to watch this. I have to watch these games. So if it allows me to escape for a little while, then great. I have a built-in excuse. Yeah, see.
Yeah, see, I feel like the NBA schedule was the, I'm just going to go sit and watch basketball, you know, and you guys do that. Now, how many nights a week can you say, hey, babe, I have to watch this Lions-Browns game for work tomorrow. No, I have to watch this. It's that important. I know Texas, yes, I know we're not Texas fans, but that, it's, this game is that big.
It is that important, yeah.
Texas Colts, I have to watch this.
Yeah.
I have to.
Yeah. By the way, some other young starting rosters in the NBA compared to North Carolina. Orlando, their average age is just under 23 years. Blazers, their starting five is 23 years of age. Memphis is 23 years of age. Pistons, 23. Oklahoma City, 23 years, a little more than that. And then North Carolina is a little under 23 years of age. You get these guys who are like 25 and 26. It's an enormous advantage. If you have talent, And you happen to be 25 years of age playing in college basketball, that is a great, great advantage. Because think about when you got to college at 18 or 19, and I remember when I got there, and I was 6'3", maybe 170 pounds, and all of a sudden you see some of these guys who were 22, 23, and they outweighed me by 40 pounds. By the time you catch up to that, you know, that there's a big difference. You look back and you go, God, how did I survive? And these guys who were 24, 25, 26, I mean, those are men playing against boys. All right, we'll come up with a poll question. Your phone calls are always welcome. We'll hear from the commissioner, Roger Goodell. No, he's not going to be on the show, just from the press conference yesterday. Didn't want to get your hopes up. Yes, Paul?
I'm calling my shot. We're getting him before next year.
I don't want him.
Oh, so okay, then I retract it.
Yeah, I don't want him. Like
are you telling me we can't pursue?
Yeah, I don't want him.
Okay.
Yeah.
That'd be an awesome, like just saying no. Like, sorry, we got Mike Tannenbaum in that segment.
Yeah, can't. I can't get squeeze you in there, Commissioner. Sorry. I mean, we've tried. We've been respectable. It's just there has to be a problem on their end. But then maybe I've been critical of the NFL, and a lot of journalists don't do that.
Fairly critical of the NFL.
I don't go out of my way to criticize them.
We don't make anything up.
Yeah. Yes, Tony.
I have a note here saying Monday, December 27, 2027. How does that sound? Could you make that one work?
I got the joke there. All right. So after I leave.
Be the Monday after the last Christmas Eve show.
LOL.
Yeah. Yeah. It's okay. Todd, when are you retiring?
God willing, Friday, Christmas Eve, 2027. But okay. That's just retiring from this show.
Yeah.
And I'm still young enough where something has to happen after that.
When are you going to start looking?
I wasn't planning on looking anytime soon, but I will. I got bills to pay, and I'm not retirement age when we wrap it up in 3 3/4 years or whatever. So there has to be life at post Danette for all of us, I would think.
Okay. All right. Let me know if you need a reference.
I appreciate that. That's kind of you.
I'm not the reference. Oh, just let me know if you need one.
Just a collect
the German
references.
Is going to.
Yeah, the big German will.
He's going to be handling
Mario. Mario sign up, or maybe P.A. Ray.
Fair enough.
You imagine the people at ESPN looking at it going, who is this P.A. Ray guy? And who's the big German? Todd's references. All right. Taking a break. We'll come back. Got a few things to talk about. And the kickoff fallout. Also, does anybody have a problem with too much NFL around the holidays? Back after this. You've put it off long enough. It's time to replace your tires. And TireRack.com has the game that will help elevate your drive. Touring tires if you're a commuter. Performance tires. Sporty handling. All-terrain tires. On- and off-road adventuring. Go to TireRack.com. Get started. They have the tire decision guide. You get a personalized tire recommendation, about 2 minutes or less. Right tires for how and what and where you drive. Choose from the full lineup of Continental tires. Ship fast and free to you or a recommended installer near you. Also, ask about mobile tire installation. Game changer here. That means they bring the tires to your home or office and install them on site. Doesn't get much easier than that. Go to TireRack.com/Dan. You'll see the Continental test results, tire ratings, consumer reviews, and check out all the current special offers they have. Great tires, great people, and a great deal. Can't ask for more. TireRack.com. TireRack.com is the way tire buying should be.
A lot of us spend our lives wishing we had more time. The question is, time for what? What's the first thing you'd do if you had an extra hour in your day? Maybe you'd see a movie by yourself, take a rejuvenating nap, curl up with a good book, or catch up with an old friend. Or maybe you just enjoy doing nothing for once. The best way to squeeze that special thing into your schedule is to know what's important to you so that you can make it a priority. And therapy can help you figure that out. A therapist can guide you through the process of defining your values and understanding your priorities, so you know what things you can spend your time on that will really fulfill you. Otherwise, you'll always be wishing for more time. BetterHelp offers convenient, affordable online therapy that comes to you. Start the process in minutes and switch therapists anytime. Learn how to make time for what makes you happy with BetterHelp. Visit BetterHelp.com/rightchoice today to get 10% off your first month. That's BetterHelp, HELP.com/rightchoice.
You can live out your MasterChef dreams when you find a professional on Angie to tackle your dream kitchen remodel. Connect with skilled professionals to get all your home projects done well. Inside to outside, repairs to renovations. Get started on the Angie app or visit Angie.com today. You can do this when you Angie that.
The less your business spends, the more margin you keep. But everything else costs more. Smart businesses are graduating to NetSuite by Oracle. NetSuite is the number one cloud financial system that brings accounting, financial management, inventory, HR onto one platform. It reduces IT costs, and over 37,000 companies have already made the move. Now through April 15th, NetSuite is offering one-of-a-kind flexible financial programs. Head to netsuite.com/Patrick.
From the Whatever It Takes Moss Nissan Traffic Center.
WDAE.
Traffic update.
Crash on eastbound Bush Boulevard near Twin Lakes and traffic slow from just east of Himes. Also, we're seeing delays in Pasco on southbound Little Road. Before Ridge Road, a crash near San Miguel Drive. Delays on southbound Veterans and State Road 60 near the airport approaching 275 and southbound 275. Still a bit slow just south of Fowler Avenue. With traffic, I'm Randy Myers.
This report is sponsored by Rasmussen University.
I had so many dreams, but life quickly got in the way. Then Rasmussen University saw my true potential and gave me the support and confidence I needed to become who I am today.
Rasmussen University. Learn more at rasmussen.edu/Florida.
And we're live here outside the Perez family home just waiting for the... And there they go! Almost on time this morning. Mom is coming out the front door strong with a double-arm kid carry. Looks like Dad has the bags. Daughter is bringing up the rear. Oh, but the diaper bag wasn't closed. Diapers and toys are everywhere. Ooh, but Mom has just nailed the perfect car seat buckle for the toddler. And now the eldest daughter, who looks to be about 9 or 10, has secured herself in the booster seat. Dad zips the bag closed, and they're off. Ah, but looks like Mom doesn't realize her coffee cup is still on the roof of the car. And there it goes. Oh, that's a shame. That mug was a fam favorite.
Don't sweat the small stuff. Just nail the big stuff. Like making sure your kids are buckled correctly in the right seat for their age and size. Learn more at nhtsa.gov/the right seat.
Visit nhtsa.gov/the right seat.
Brought to you by NHTSA and the Ad Council.
Trade-A-Thon is always one of Brandon Ford's most popular sales events. So Trade-A-Thon 2024 is going to be unbelievable.
Going to be unbelievable.
You want to get rid of all those toys you don't want anymore? Cars, trucks, boats, campers, motorcycles. We don't care if you have to tow it in or push it that last mile. But you don't need to trade anything to get our Trade-A-Thon deals.
You don't need to trade anything to get our Trade-A-Thon deals.
Like gorgeous new 2024 F-150 Crew Cab STXs with the black appearance package, huge 12-inch touchscreen, and premium 20-inch wheels and a custom spray and bed liner for just $46,699.
$46,699.
We have 100 of these trucks, or get 1.9% for 72 months on new 2023 F-150s.
Please note, during the sale, every customer qualifies for the branded Ford price.
And no other Ford dealer in this part of the country can beat that price. No hidden fees during Trade-A-Thon 2024 at Brandon Ford, the largest volume Ford truck dealer in America. Highway 60 and 301 in Tampa, and at BrandonFord.com.
Hi, Andrew Duncan of the Duncan Duo team. We're now part of LPT Realty, one of the fastest growing real estate companies in the country. A great change for us, but what hasn't changed is our guarantee to get your home sold in 14 days. Visit us at DuncanDuo.com. That's DuncanDuo.com.
By now, you've heard all of our ads. America's largest injury law firm. It means that when you hire us, you get a legal army. When it comes to law, size matters. Morgan & Morgan. Visit ForThePeople.com for an office near you.
Running to a meeting or just need to get away? No problem. Download the free iHeartRadio app, where you can take WDAE and your home for sports, music, talk, and podcasts all in one app. Free never sounded so good. Presented by the law offices of Anajar and Levine, accident attorneys. Call 1-800-747-FREE.
That's 1-800-747-3733.
Miss the Pat and Aaron Show this morning? Check out the Pat and Aaron Show full show podcast now on iHeartRadio. Now more with the Dan Patrick Show on WDAE.
DanPatrick.com. All right. Poll question, Seton. What are we going to go with?
Yeah, we're going to stick with, can there be too much NFL?
Okay.
Can there be too much NFL? Your options are going to be some form of not in a million years or definitely.
All right. Is there too much?
Can there be, not is there.
Can there
Very big be. Difference to
okay.
me.
Okay, all right.
Can there be?
All right. David in Arkansas. David, too much NFL?
Good morning, gentlemen. Yes, I have had Kansas City Chiefs season tickets for 23 years now, and I do live in South Arkansas. It is over a 1,000-mile round trip for me to go to the games, and I just think at times – the NFL needs to think about these people called fans, these people who actually go to the games on a Wednesday. That's 3 days off work for me. Even if it is Christmas, I still work. You know,
David, they know there's blind loyalty. Thanks for the phone call. If you don't go, somebody else will go. And somebody will take your season tickets. Yes, Eden.
But is that the right thing to do, is treat season ticket holders essentially like running backs?
No.
Don't really care. I mean, pay your whatever the licensing fees are for your seat that somehow you're charging you twice for the same seat.
Oh, I know.
And then, hey, if you don't show up, then we don't really care. Somebody else will. So
yes,
get in.
I think that's the way they view this. You know, the times when they'll change a game and you'll have a cold weather city and they're playing later in the evening, they're not thinking about the fans. They're putting on marquee game, and then those fans are sitting out there. I mean, the number of fans in Kansas City who were there for the playoff game who had amputations because of, you know, the cold that they had. I mean, that's remarkable. I think it was like 12 fans had amputations. Yes, Todd?
It's not just football, but the lack of effort, just on a smaller note, besides price gouging and merchandise and food, they get you into that game. They could care less if it takes you 4 hours to get out of the parking lot when it can just take a few people helping move it around. So
but
you
that's
don't
not do... necessarily the NFL.
No, that's all arenas and stadiums. But I've gone to my share of all of them, and there's just zero.